He pressed it.
Indigo.
We're live now. Goodness me. Hi, everyone. Sorry we're a little bit late starting. We had some technical difficulties and that my iPad has decided that YouTube needs to update when there is no update for it. So it keeps on freaking out and saying I can't watch chat. So we've been trying to get that to work. And now we've given up and I'm going to be looking at my phone all the time because that's always fun too. Mm. Hope you're all doing very well. We're going to kick off with a lovely song requested by our Discord group, which is Barge Ballad.
Barge Ballad.
Barge Ballad. Everyone's favourite song about barges. And I made the mystique of eating the mystique. Starburst a minute ago, so now my mouth is all sticky.
The X-Men. X-Woman. Yeah. X-Person.
Ready? Once there was a barge lad,
way up atop the mast,
shouting to the skipper, we made it home at last. Well, I was that barge lad,
way up atop the mast.
But now I'm the skipper and that young nipper had better be holding fast.
Oh, we're loaded down with bales so high, you've got to lean backwards if you want to see the sky. Oh, the Thames may forgive us, but the yard never will. So eyes front and away we sail.
Oh, you've got to be able,
way up atop the mast.
Your legs better be nimble and your head better think fast. Well, I was that able,
way up atop the mast.
But now I'm the skipper and that young nipper is hardy enough to last.
Oh, we're loaded down with bales so high, you've got to lean backwards if you want to see the sky. Oh, the Thames may forgive us, but the yard never will. So eyes front, keep your head and away we sail.
You've got eyes like an eagle,
way up atop the mast,
spotting all the obstacles that come across your path. Well, I was that eagle,
way up atop the mast.
But now I'm the skipper and that young nipper will keep us from taking a bath.
Oh, we're loaded down with bales so high, you've got to lean backwards if you want to see the sky. Oh, the Thames may forgive us, but the old never will. So eyes front, keep your head, clear your throat and away we sail.
Oh, you've got to remember,
way up atop the mast,
knowing all the river routes that you never learned from the charts. Well, I do remember,
way up atop the mast.
But now I'm the skipper and that young nipper is taking the rivers to heart.
Oh, we're loaded down with bales so high, you've got to lean backwards if you want to see the sky. Oh, the Thames may forgive us, but the old never will. So eyes front, keep your head, clear your throat, know your way, fill your pipe, grab on tight, look for the lights and away we sail.
Yeah!
Yeah!
We did it! Hi, Robbie, over there.
Hi, how are you doing?
I've realised I centred the camera on you when you were leaning really far forwards, so now it's just like a really high up view of you and kind of the room above you.
I don't really mind.
It's going to drive me mad.
The less I get my knees in this whole thing, the better.
I'm going to have to move it in a minute, I'm sure. How's everybody doing? Welcome. Oh, and it looks like this is working now, which is kind of nice.
Really?
So
amazing.
Now we could look down at the iPad instead of looking down at our phones, because that's what we all like. That's hope you're all doing well.
Much better.
I've seen there have already been some donations and stuff. Heart of Oak Woodworking tipped.
Whoop.
Thank you ever so much.
And Craig B. Daniel.
How's the sound, everybody? Does it sound good?
It's hopefully.
Awful. Does it sound good?
I realised I forgot to save the settings after last time, so I kind of did a bit of a rejig through what was in my head at the time. So hopefully it's all right. I don't know if the pans are going to be all backwards and stuff, but I've got it quite centred anyway. It's not particularly wide, so it's probably going to be fine. Sound is spiffy. Great.
Spiffy.
Bass sounds incredible. Says El Pony Pisador.
Great.
If you haven't already heard of them, go listen to that band because they're like us, but good.
Ha!
Gooder.
I always think of us as worse El Pony Pisador.
Oh, yeah, fair enough. That'll do. Mm. But seriously, they are an amazing band. And if you haven't already heard of them, go and listen to them. And go and watch our live stream with them too because they're banging lads.
Boodot says way too much Robbie. I always agree.
Robbie sounds a bit roomish.
Somebody else says Robbie is
quiet.
Oh,
somebody get picked up on
that's
because
that mic is really far away.
It is further away from you.
Oh, he must have moved that to.
I did.
Hang on, to get at the computer.
Boatman.
How was that?
It was Boatman. Yeah.
Try not breaking his banjo and my laptop by having Boat.
I'm scared.
another stream with them. We were going to do another stream with the ponies earlier this year, and then something
stuck
weird.
In their own country.
Yeah, something happened to like the world that meant we couldn't meet up. So yes, as soon as we can, we will absolutely be back in the room with them and have a lovely time. Hopefully, Robbie's going to be the right volume now that his mic's actually
should be a little bit better. I hope that sounds a little clearer.
Get it closer if you want, even still.
Probably could.
Get mental. Go for it.
Too loud.
So hope you're all doing well. We're having a nice time so far. We've got beers, we've got snacks, we've got songs. What more could you want, really, on a Wednesday evening?
Money.
Speaking of...
I'm joking. Well, not. But anyway.
So if you are new to the channel, first of all, hello and welcome to our madness that is our singing band live streams. We are going to be singing a bunch of songs. We'd like to chat a load of nonsense in the middle and tell you about goings on with us and other things that we find interesting as well in between. And yeah, you'll notice there is a big old song list down the bottom. Those are the songs that are currently leading the charts for the ones that have been donated for and requested. So if there is a specific song you are desperate to hear, we have a song list, which is in the description below, or it's probably going to appear in the chat as well in just a second. Of all the different songs that we're kind of able to do for these quite happily, there's possibly some new ones that we need to add on there at some point. There will be.
I put some on every now and
again. They put some on. That's
maybe just put some surprise songs.
Yeah.
So all the kind of tips, donations, and members, that sort of thing, if you've heard of that before, all the donations, that sort of stuff, goes towards the different songs people want, as well as sending us lovely messages too, which Dave reads out intermittently too.
I do.
So if there's something you really want to say to us that's lovely, or just you want to call us rude names, but don't do that really, because that's mean, then yeah, Dave will read all those out. We try and read chat as much as we can, but obviously because there's quite a lot of you, stuff gets missed. So if there are any kind of questions and things you want to ask us, we have a wonderful squad of moderators out there. I've seen a few already. I can see Boodot, who's been chatting a fair bit a few times.
Sam's
out there.
Arian's.
Possibly. I haven't seen Arian for a
bit.
Arian's there.
Bloomis is there.
Bloomis. Oh, all the gang's here. Fantastic. They're an amazing team, and they'll be forwarding me questions that you guys say. So if we miss it, don't worry. It has been read by someone. And yes, I'll do some of our... some of the questions that were forwarded, basically, as we're going through. Is that everything?
So.
That's how the stream works.
Lost in chat there for a second.
Zen, so many moderators.
Anathema's there. I've missed Zen. We didn't get the random song facts last stream because Anathema wasn't here.
I'm gonna have to move this down.
You're pointing that down a bit.
Too high. Stop being so high.
Way too high. Bring me down a peg. There we go. That's better. I like it. Yes.
You can see just the tip of the harmonium.
Which is exactly all you need of a harmony.
Sound helps.
So, pretty much we're just going to sing through what's tipping the list at the time. In case you were confused, any donations towards songs, even if you don't see them appear on the bottom, they are all being totaled up and counted by Dave. So all the different songs have different running totals as they're going along. So all the donations get counted.
Dave,
they all add towards different songs. And yes.
Also, if you are a member at any level, you get a free song choice. I put a comment in the community section of YouTube that you can go find, and I will check it throughout the stream. So you can do that, including Mustache Ninja, who just became a wide jar.
Woo!
Thanks, Mustache Ninja.
Thank you very much. So yeah, all of the membership amounts go towards different songs on these streams as well. So there you go. All dandy and good. Right, should we sing a song then? I feel like that's enough PSA for now.
Yes.
I think that is.
Okay. So what's currently tipping the tops?
Is it still Ashes?
I want to watch that old fire as it flickers and then dies in that order.
Ready to listen to me tune.
Okay.
Perfect.
Well.
You've lost
perfect.
It.
Perfect.
All money will go towards getting Andy more pen lids to put on his banjo.
I can afford big pens myself. This is going to be a great noise.
This is the wonderful tuning song. Oh yeah, also if you become a member, that's a really good point, you unlock all of our custom emotes for the channel. So
Hype
we've got
cow.
Hype Cow, I love the Hype Cow. There's Adequate, which if you're new here, it's kind of a bit of a running joke, it actually means it was really good. As far as we know. Well, we hope. We hope it's Stormy's.
That's the secret.
There's the Quacken Heart, the Quacken himself, the Nailed It, Posh Quacken, and Friendly Fire, of course. I love him. Can I borrow that after you as well? Unless mine's over there too.
There's a lot of pictures of our faces on there.
Not on YouTube, that's on Discord. That's on Discord madness. I can just assume this is in tune. Probably tuned these beforehand, but there we go.
Too many different tunings.
It's A major, G sharp, that one bit. Then
all over it, Robbie.
Oh yeah. We've been doing this all the time on the Twitch streams on the Sea of Thieves.
I'm very glad.
Right. Give us some toot, Rob.
Toot, Rob. Yeah. I'll do it with the harmonium this time. How about that?
Watch that old fire as it flickers and dies. Though once blessed the household and lit up our life, it shone for the friends and the clinking of glasses. I'll tend to the flame, you can worship the ashes. Capture the wild things and bring them in line. And own what was never your right to confine. The lives and the loves and the songs are what matters. I'll tend to the flame, you can worship the ashes. Do you feel heavy, your eyes drop with grief? Your spirit is wild and your suffering is brief. Though never you buckle and bend to the masses, I'll tend to the flame, you can worship the ashes. Get round a fire with a glass of strong ale, and tell us a story from beyond the pale. Bury some seeds and expect some strong branches. I'll tend to the flame, you can worship the ashes. Now show me a man that can meet all his needs. For what we need most now is unity, see. A common old song for all creeds and all classes. I'll tend to the flame, worship the ashes. I'll tend to the flame. What will we do when the world it is ending, and time it is halted for friend and for foe? Try to hold on to the time as it passes. I'll tend to the flame, you can worship the ashes. I'll tend to the flame, you can worship the ashes. I'll tend to the flame, you can worship the ashes.
Yeah. Fade away.
Well, Robbie Anathema says everything about this sounds like a Dick Goffman song. So, congrats.
Well,
That's quite a compliment then, isn't it? I need to do it in a Scottish accent now, and you need to play the guitar a lot more elaborately. Whoa. Oh, I'm in that chair.
No, that's my chair. That's all right. Yeah, that's a good one.
This has got a lot of give on the back.
Yeah. Don't crush the guitar behind you.
Yeah, so just stay very as balanced as I can.
Do you want some donation messages?
I would love to hear some donation messages.
Oh,
thanks,
well.
Dave Bot.
I thought you were going to say we'd like some donuts for a second.
No, I wish I had donuts. Craig B. Daniel wants Andy's Choice. Heart of Oak Woodworking says, Andy, we are so happy for the full band stream. Raven for Oak and Ash and Thorn. Helga Max says, 4 hours for Hung and his mum.
Yeah.
Darley parents say, JD's Choice, because he chooses a good one. We are his mum and dad.
There's actually nothing to feel bad about them requesting a Robbie song last time.
Hessington says, loving that I can catch your streams lately. You guys rock. Would love to hear Fathom. Bo. Jeffrey wants, here's a health. Robert Cameraman, The Parting Glass. If you could play that, it would be terrific.
Ooh,
me and a good friend have it in our will that it will be played when either of us dies. Wow, keep it light. Now recently he started on the journey for treating his clinical depression. Oh, that's great. Nice one, Robin. Nerd for Oak and Ash and Thorn as well.
Yay.
Hooray.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you very much.
Oh, yeah, also, I'm still checking members.
Absolutely, yes. Good times. Thank you so much for all the donations, everyone. That's super, super kind, and so many already. Right. Oh, isn't that nice?
A little fuzzy feeling.
That warm, fuzzy Wednesday night feeling. It's good. It's felt weird this last month, like taking like a month until we've done the next one.
That's me.
Yeah.
Yeah. After getting used to doing them every 2 weeks, it's like...
You really did get used to it.
Yeah, yeah. You kind of feel like, man.
We don't want to oversaturate the thing, though. You know?
Yeah.
Want it to be fun every time and not be like... scrambling for ideas.
It feels like more of a special event when we can do it once a month. Definitely. It is a good thing. And it means we can generally go on a little bit longer as well, which is cool. Because we're trying to do them a bit shorter when we're doing it every 2 weeks. Again, for the same kind of reasons, but there we go. Well, and yeah, for folks saying you don't have money to be able to donate and everything, do not worry at all. Like, obviously, it means a huge amount to us when people can and do, because like it allows us to be able to keep on doing this and basically keep on being a band and making stuff. But if you can't, we completely understand that as well, especially with everything going on with the world and whatnot. So do not worry. Sit back, enjoy the show, have a great time, and we'll sing some lovely songs for you anyway. But if you do still want to help out, like, there's still loads of stuff you can do, like liking this video, going through and liking our other videos, commenting on stuff, and subscribing to the channel if you're not already, because all of those things help YouTube's algorithm and stuff realize that people are watching our things and go, oh yeah, we should show that to more people. And so it all helps what we do. It's all very much appreciated. And I do read every single comment. I'm not sure there's one that I haven't read on the YouTube channel. Because I got the old studio app on my phone and I go through and check them off and like, oh yeah, that's cool, that's nice.
We're testing that with a fake account soon.
You're going to see the comment. I don't reply to them all. I reply to all the ones like after we've released a video. And occasionally like, people ask questions and stuff like that, which I try to. I try and do as much as I can, but there's a point where you're just replying to comments all the time.
Yeah.
And it's a bit too much.
Another message from Heart of Oak Woodworking. And Louise, donating is not nice. It's selfish. I want to hear my choices.
Well, that's fair one enough. Way of looking at it, yeah.
Okay, where's Andy's choice now?
It's again, like, below lots of
I start
things.
Getting like super stressed out when it gets near the top.
It's fine, it's not
to anybody. Whoever donates for my choice.
Have you already decided what it's going to be?
No.
Red Napper.
I don't, because I don't know what.
Why,
John? Fair. I'm going to check what questions I've been asked already. For everybody.
So one or two.
It's supposed to be questions. Oh dear, Moby Duck is right at the top of
it's
isn't it?
Right there.
Oh,
very close.
Very excited. Oh, yeah, I've got to get the bass out at some point, haven't I? Look at that. More wide Johns appearing. Thank you so much.
Wow.
Red Napper.
Good.
That's a good name.
Bread, what was it?
Just make you chuckle.
Bread,
only one question so far, and it's a bit of a loaded question. But I guess we could do something a little bit
more.
I've been asked, do we have any packages or presents arrive from the US? Definitely asking for no reasons. I don't actually know. I'm not sure whether the thing from that person has arrived.
I was going to... No, I don't think so.
Don't think so.
We've got this...
Not yet, but we do have some other things
wait,
that open.
Who's this from?
Which is very exciting.
This?
Well, it's not from... It's not from the US because it says New Zealand.
It also says who it's from on the back.
It does say.
Oh, that's what I'm asking. I couldn't,
so we've been sent some cool things, which hopefully we can get the postal address up on the screen. Because we have a PO box and people have been sending us cool stuff. We've got some great decorations. At some point very soon, I think we're going to take down a lot of the stuff which is up here and redecorate with the things that you guys have sent in.
Yeah,
we've got like this guy here, like another little Kraken. We've got this guy.
And the Generation iPod. 1 iPod.
Yeah.
I mean, basically everything on that shelf can go.
Yeah.
Yes.
My old PC cooling fan.
There's a lot of filler in there.
A showy but not very good microphone.
Did you watch a video on how to create a YouTube stream background?
Especially my stuff.
No.
Holy smokes.
So we got sent
a few plushies.
Actually, if I pass these to you, you've got a better camera to be able to show these.
Quick question for you, JD. Is that a Corridor Digital shirt?
What? Yes, it is. How did you know?
Exclamation point merch in the chat.
Yeah, I should have worn one of our shirts, to be fair. Oh, we could show off our hoodies. Do we all have them?
Oh, I've got my hoodie.
Mine's upstairs.
Have you got yours?
Oh, Dave's.
I've got mine.
We'll do that in a minute.
What, ours?
Yeah, ours.
Yeah, we'll do both. We'll show off ours and we'll show off the...
I don't have mine, but you've got
Oh, do you not?
Sorry.
So yours is the most dramatic.
I've been waiting to tie that.
Anyway, so, do you want to, if you show off what that is? It's on.
It's an autofocus or
something. No. So you need to be back where you are, otherwise it's going to be way out of focus.
So but how are people supposed to see it?
It's just a bit closer on your
screen. They can stick their faces really close to the...
People's screens are... Some people have really big screens.
Yeah. Oh, it's a map of New Zealand, either way, and it's got a message.
It's a wooden postcard.
Would you like to read?
You can look on that screen, Robbie.
It doesn't feel very effective.
Oh, yeah. Good point, Dave. Right. How close can I get this without it going out of focus? Like there.
About there. That'll do.
About there.
All right, so what we've got here, for those of you that can't see, which is probably everybody, New Zealand, little map. I assume this is somebody's...
Well, it says it on the back.
Woodprint, right? Oh, it's a postcard! See that?
Yeah.
It's too concentrated on trying to... Can I read it out?
I think so. I think it's all right. Oh, do you want to read it in your head whilst I show off another thing?
Okay.
Just in case. Because I know this is super lovely. We opened this on a Sea of Thieves stream on Twitch the other day. But a lovely, lovely message from Bowie Hair. They've made us this incredible thing. This is made from foam. You don't want to.
I like foam.
You don't want to use it for what it looks
cool.
Can I poke it? Crack it?
I haven't actually touched it yet.
Have you not?
I'd like to touch
it.
Yeah,
you haven't, have you?
Oh yeah, that, and it came that in this, feels much lighter than it looks.
It came in this badass box.
A little bit squidgy.
I'm impressed with both.
Yeah,
that is cool. That's deceptively light.
That is 100% shelf worthy.
Yep.
Absolutely. Mm. That is going on display very much so.
Thanks, Barry.
I feel like it pretty would cool. Hold liquid. It just
Dave's going to try to drink it.
Yeah, yeah.
Chemicals.
It would have quite a chemically taste.
I'll walk to the studio one day. Dave's going to.
Speaking of weird tasting things, I tried to make some homemade lemonade the other day, and it was really good. Like, squeeze the lemons, put sugar, boil it, that sort of thing, cook it up and cool it.
Yeah.
Except I made it in the wok. Because I wanted the quantity.
Oh, okay.
It picked up some wok flavour.
Yeah.
So it kind of tastes like...
Sweet chilli lemonade.
Yeah. It definitely got like this whole, meaty chilli flavour.
Doesn't on the whole sound like a bad thing. Could be chilli lemonade. Could be good.
Yeah.
Made purposely.
It's not good.
Do you want to touch this, Robbie? Or
stream
right?
Broke.
Someone else needs to read this. I'm not.
Everyone's saying stream
about.
Broke.
An error occurred. F. Uh-oh. No. Rip. Mine died. New. Stream broke.
Uh-oh.
Error.
Fresh it.
F.
It looks fine over there. This looks like a YouTube problem.
Oh. Oh dear.
My stream looks.
Mine's gone. There we go.
Mine's okay, but I might be behind.
It's back. Oh, we back. Back.
Saying it's back. Good.
Everybody, back. Refresh your stream.
YouTube's having a. They can't hear you say that if the stream's
refresh.
Broken, Andy.
Every doesn't matter. It's the best I can do.
It's fine. Mine's back
as well. It's fine.
Goodness me. Sorry about that, everyone. I wasn't us at our end. Our PC's fine. It's not dropped frames or anything. Mm. So that must have been a YouTube bug.
It's fine. You only missed JD's riveting lemonade story.
Yeah, I don't know how much of it you heard. I made duff lemonade because I made it in the wrong pan. It tastes all silly. We got this to show off. Which is
you
very
can
cool.
Live here.
Are you finished reading yet?
I am. I'm not sure what a lot of it actually. How to pronounce a lot of it. Is this like.
Got a message.
It's just a thing saying.
Imagine this note is written neatly.
I will. I don't actually remember reading this.
Do you not?
No.
Merry Printmas.
Hello, Johns. I'll preface what Jay's about to show. Hello, Johns. Merry Printmas. Feel free to display or burn this as desired. From Danny. And
check this out. This is amazing. Where's the light? Where's the light reflection? There we go. If I hold it down, it doesn't reflect so much.
Oh, nice.
Beautiful.
It's all that at the bottom.
It's so cool.
Do you want to do
it's got us at the bottom.
Do you want to do a quick
I'm going to do a close-up on this, yeah.
Let's do a close-up. Worth a close-up, that one, I think.
You hold this.
Yes.
And we'll do it on this camera.
Oh, yes.
Right. Oh, coming closer? I'll focus on.
Coming closer.
Breaking the fourth wall.
Even closer.
Quite bright. Yay. Wait, look, there's us at the bottom there. And remember, that's the octopus from the
album. And we are about to face it.
What are we doing? And we're about to face it with nothing but guitars. What fools! How cool is that? That is definitely going on.
And that was the end of the longest Johns.
The power of folk.
It's a bit like that scene from Tenacious D.
That's a bit, isn't it?
So yeah, if you wanna send us exciting things, then yes, send to the PO box.
We
will enjoy and look at. But yeah, how cool is that? Longest John's movie when? Gosh, that's the next Kickstarter.
Yeah. Animated movie. Yeah. Longest John's Under the Sea, Fight the Kraken.
I'd watch it. I wouldn't.
It'd be like they didn't like. That Kiss made a movie in the late 80s, didn't they? It'd probably just be like that. Or we have to look, we're all just us, and we have to save a fairground or something.
I was thinking more like
Tenacious D movie.
Yeah, I mean, you've got all the money for that.
I mean, it's all good, right? Cool. I guess that's enough for now. Let's do another song, shall we?
Hang on, I've just put the address. There it is.
Oh, yeah, it's over Robbie's head. So if you want to send stuff to us, send it there. Longest John's, Cabaret Studios, PO Box 130, Bristol, BSF and 1BU.
That's 1BU.
And yeah, that'll get to us.
The U is short for you.
I thought it was short for umbrella.
For upstanding citizen.
Under my upstanding citizen. No.
And the BS is for?
Yeah. I don't know.
Oh, more donations. Are there any other things
Big
to read?
Big sandwich.
Yes. Things to read. Casper, a surname that I would probably butcher if I tried to read it. Craig Puth, maybe?
Craig Puth,
sure.
Fantastic as always, guys. Would you ever think about singing Row Me Bully Boys by the Rambling Sailors? That sounds like a stereotypical shanty name.
That's very traditional
maybe
shanty
Maybe we'll
name,
look it up.
Yeah, I can't say I know it off the top of my head.
Accurate once Northwest Passage. Yeah. Furious Tumbler Nachos.
Great.
Ayo, I've been getting into guitar again, partially due to your music. Thanks, YouTube recommended. Is there any place to find chord charts or tabs for your songs or any plan for something like that? If not, I'll continue to struggle on.
Ooh, well, we are working on songbooks. That's happening. There are unofficial chords which aren't completely accurate because I've looked at them and they weren't spot on Ultimate Guitar. And if you want to learn how to play Oak and Ash and Thorn, I did a several hour stream kind of going through all the different parts and showing people how to do that. So if you want to do that. And we were chatting earlier today actually about doing some more kind of instructional videos and stuff as well. So keep an eye out in the future for more things like that.
Also, there's a book that might help in the future.
I mentioned that at the start.
I wasn't listening.
Yeah, we're working. We're working on a songbook, so there's a few albums to get through. So, but it is progressing.
And Anonymous says, catch you at halftime and later on YouTube. Sorry, you narrowly edged out to footy, trophy presentation and all.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
If it's trophy presentation, I assume Liverpool.
Kick team.
Oh.
And sports team. Men.
You might have guessed we're not sports.
We're not people. Sports.
Oh, that's as far as I can even take that sentence. I know so little about it.
I mean, I know that you score the shoot point by putting the...
You get the foot and you put the ball with the foot in the... in the
rigging.
The rigging. Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
That would be useful rigging, so
on. What song's next?
Northwest Passage.
Oh! Great. I'm ready for that. Who's ready for a Northwest sausage? Oh, I've seen, actually, some people have just been buying some stuff on the website. If you haven't already seen, look, we got like mugs
and
we got tankards. If you like our stuff and want to get yourself some things, that's all on our website.
Mm.
LongestJones.com.
Dave's customised his with some
it's got Adventure Time bands on because we've got four, and we got one each, and
We've already experienced on doing a video shoot that they get misplaced easily, so marking them is a good plan. Right, can I have my sausage note?
Three more donations. Wow.
That's not a thing.
We'll do them after.
I think the rule should be, if the note's been tooted, then we go with it. Until that point.
Two notes were tooted at once.
Until that point, it's anyone's game for what song.
Right.
Okay. Was that it? R4. Ready?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not singing the melody this time.
No.
Just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one worn line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea.
Westward from the Davis Strait, 'tis there 'twas said to lie, the sea route to the Orient, for which so many died, seeking gold and glory, leaving weathered broken bones, and a long forgotten lonely cairn of stone. For
just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one worn line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea.
3 centuries thereafter, I take passage over land in the footsteps of brave Kelsey, where his sea of flowers began. Watching cities arise before me, then behind me sink again, this tardiest explorer driving hard across the plain.
For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one worn line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea.
And through the night behind the wheel, the mileage clicking west, I think upon Mackenzie, David Thompson and the rest, who cracked the mountain ramparts and did show a path for me to race the roaring Fraser to the sea.
For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a Northwest Passage to the sea.
How then am I so different from the first men through this way? Like them, I left a settled life, I threw it all away, to seek a Northwest Passage at the call of many men, and to find there but the road back home again.
For just one time I would take the Northwest Passage to find the hand of Franklin reaching for the Beaufort Sea, tracing one warm line through a land so wide and savage, and make a northwest passage to the sea.
Some random people in chat called El Pony P. Isador.
Paisador.
Paisador, really. Say, hey, we love that one.
Thanks, guys.
Yay. That's because we did a pretty banging video with them of that song.
Banging.
Banging. It was.
It's on the Caraway Studios channel, isn't it?
Caraway Music.
Caraway Music.
Caraway Music is the name of that channel, in fact. Which we haven't been able to do anything for ages because, like, baby.
I think it's gotten them.
and virus. Pretty much. But yeah. Anyone want a cool spoiler? We're currently in chats and working on making a thing with the ponies. It's very early stages, but just gonna say we are definitely making a thing with them. So
I don't say definitely. There could be another global pandemic.
That's fine.
We're trying. We're trying to make a thing with them.
Yes, we are starting to make progress by in which we talked about it, and we have a vague idea of what we're going to do. So there we go. Much excite. I can't wait because that's going to be really good.
But you have to.
I have to wait. And you have to wait. And you have to wait. And you have to. No, you can't. What? You're all right. You can have it now.
Oh, good. So where is it?
I'm done with this bit. I got lost halfway.
I was trying to push you and see
work out how to dig your way out of it.
Nope. I just plain give up.
I'll give you a spade, you have to dig your own hole.
But yes, it's going to be cool. Were there some more donations?
Yeah.
I thought there were.
There's eating a question.
Do you want me to do some questions first whilst you're eating Christmas?
No. Anonymous says, JD's choice, please.
Woo! Thank you very much, Anonymous.
Newton Baylor says, I discovered you through El Pony... and I absolutely love you guys.
Yeah.
Say his prayers. It's my favorite chanty. And then Kathy Patton with the semi hundo.
Kathy, what?
Semi?
Semi hundo.
Like a 50.
That's 50.
Okay. Wow. Thank you so much.
So I have a request for my son, Wyatt, aka Flux Swinger. Rocky Road to Dublin.
Thanks very much.
Such a balm for the soul.
And big love to Wyatt as well.
Thanks for helping us keep sane during these difficult times. Fans for life, Kathy and Wyatt Patton. In is that Washington, Seattle, sure.
Yeah, that'll do. Thank you very much, everyone. That's super kind, super generous. Tell you what, before we do some questions, there's a couple of mentions I would like to give from like things that we know and things that people have messaged us. So one of our wonderful followers, who we're really good friends with, and is like. Made amazing drawings and stuff of all of us. And is there anything on the wall by them at the moment?
Oh,
not sure. Don't think so. Not on the wall, but there's lots of stuff on like all our Discord profiles.
Who are
something.
You talking about?
Speedy Wheels. Oh, Speedy Wheels. Yeah. It's their birthday yesterday. So happy birthday, Speedy.
Happy birthday.
It was yesterday, wasn't it?
Birthday. I'm not sure.
Yesterday or the day before.
Yeah.
I'm sure we'll be corrected.
But either
chat
way, I wanted to mention now. It. I probably should have looked it up in more detail first. But big love to you, Speedy. And also, I want to give a special mention, because I got a really, really lovely email the other day from a chap wanting me to give a special mention and shout out to their son, Mr. Mikey Dussault, and I hope I'm pronouncing that right, because I've been told they had pretty much a rubbish year with like stuff going on with their house burning down, and then obviously all of this stuff with the virus and whatnot, and they just graduated high school. And about to go off and study chemical engineering, which sounds pretty badass. Mm-hmm. We're making jokes about
Walter White. What it actually was.
just be
trying cooking, to figure out what it was.
Cooking
first.
Meth.
That's what I would say if I was cooking meth. Yeah.
Definitely not. Basically all the... I'm sure this applies to a lot of you as well. But like prom and graduation, that sort of stuff has been cancelled. And so we just wanted to send a bit of love because we know that they're a big fan. And so all the best from us, lots of love, and good luck with chemical engineering. That sounds pretty badass and smarter than I can handle.
Engineer those chemicals.
If I ever needed any chemicals engineered, I now know where to call.
We now know who to call.
Longest John's brand chemicals.
Absolutely. That's just beer, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Anything, literally anything.
So yeah, lots of love from us. I hope you're watching, and if not, then I'll definitely get in contact and say to watch this back, because, you know, you're cool. And thanks for listening to all of our stuff and being a fan. We really appreciate it. Yeah? You lied, didn't you? You did. Oh, I checked it and everything. One more question. How's Leave a Johnny song coming along? It's actually coming along all right at the moment. We've compiled a bunch of videos. We may, I still need to look at the rules, but we may need to put it on a little bit of hold because we may need to do some like double checking and contact people to make sure we have permission in case people are under 18. I'm not entirely sure what the rules are now. And looking back, I did say about it in one of the videos, but to cover all of our bases, because I don't have any submitted permissions, we don't want it to get pulled down because someone says, I didn't say that. So we may have to put it on hold for a little bit, but we have been compiling all the videos and putting it together and starting to make a thing. So it is on its way again. But yes, we obviously had to delay it with the album launch. I was hoping to get it out before, couldn't do it.
Is that?
And yeah, did someone say Carrillo's here?
Is that the real Carrillo in chat?
The real Carrillo! Yeah! Oh, Carrillo is another really good friend of ours.
Great.
He is a fantastic streamer over on Twitch. If you like your games to be fun and spicy, go and watch Carrillo, because he is a great streamer.
Alternatively, if you like your games to be boring and other things.
Are you going
to
say, watch us?
Is this a self-claim? Is that what you do?
Yeah. Well, so we're filling a gap in the market, I think.
Michael Duso says, the boy and I are absolutely watching. Thank you.
Yay.
Yeah, thank you so much. Oh, glad you're here.
Carrillo.
Big love.
So good.
Big love.
One boat.
One boat. But yeah, if you like, especially lots of Sea of Thieves, Carrillo is a fantastic streamer in Sea of Thieves, and as I say, a good friend of ours, and a really good singer as well. Much character.
Oh, he's big character.
Big character on the sings. I love it. One more question then. I just wondered if the Johns might come to Portsmouth at any point.
There's a few other questions along the lines of Pampol and Renaissance fairs, which have the same answer as...
Yes, they pretty much all do. We were actually going to be going to Portsmouth this year, but it got cancelled.
I was actually going to go down to Portsmouth soon at some point anyway, because there was like, I think there's the Mary Rose ship, like an old... I think it was one of Francis Drake's ships that they found on the bed and then brought it up, and now it's a museum. There was another ship, I think, like some kind of tea clipper there as well.
Ooh, great.
And we're running out of song material, ladies and gentlemen. We used all our stuff on the album, and now we're going to start coming up with new songs, so I'm going to go down anyway and sort of have a look around one of those.
That sounds really cool.
They look really cool.
Yeah, we could
make a van trip of it.
We had a couple of gigs booked in Portsmouth, didn't we, before lockdown started.
There was a big festival we were going to do.
Yeah. Yeah.
But yeah, either way, the answer pretty much is
Henry VIII.
We will come most places if we're invited and we are able to make the time and afford to, basically. So Renaissance fairs and stuff, we'd love to do it. Love to do, what's the other thing you said?
Pampol.
We did Pampol once before. We would love to go again. It was a really great festival, but we just need to be invited.
Just a case of whether they invite us or not.
One of the main things Pampol does, which is true of most festivals, is if people ask for bands, it puts them on their radar and they're more likely to ask them. They usually, every time they're about to start booking people, they usually say, oh, what acts do you want to see next year? And it's definitely true that they use those kind of metrics to gauge who they should invite.
Every few days, load up your email. Have you booked the Longest Johns yet? Why are the Longest Johns coming to you? Don't do that.
But we'd absolutely love to go back there again because it was a fantastic festival. And same with Portsmouth as well. Yeah, we'll hopefully be going there next year. With the same festival, if all the bookings and stuff carry over, which in theory they all are, because that'd be really good. Mm-hmm. It was going to be a really cool festival. Too.
Yeah,
gutted. But there we go. Next time. Right, that's enough questions for now. Is it sings?
Rocky Road to Dublin.
Is it? Oh man, we haven't done this before.
We still don't all sing at the same.
Me and Andy have kind of got it
down.
Which version do you do?
I don't know.
It goes in, it someone locks it down, and then old Robbie has to learn everything again.
It's mostly the Irish Descendants.
But it's
version.
Not quite the same.
Not quite.
There's a couple of wee smidges that we change.
Wee smidges?
Wee smidges. More donations. 4,000 huffs. What's a huff?
Hang on, 4,000 huffs is £10.
Thanks very much. Just checking.
That was a second.
It's like an outward gasp.
I've never heard that description.
4,000 huffs, man.
That is fantastic. I'll give you 4,000 hours.
Hungarian forint.
Nice.
That's really cool.
Ooh. Sure.
And cool. And $20 from Mark Vandegrift.
£10, yep. Or would you rather 10 pounds or 4,000 huffs?
I'd take 4,000 huffs. I mean, it does also smell something. Sound like something to do with farts.
I don't know. You can smell it and tell me what you think.
Huff is guff.
I mean, if you huff something, I would generally assume it's unpleasant.
It goes into you, and a guff is when a fart comes out.
Yeah, but if you huff something, I would assume it's unpleasant, right?
No. Like glue.
Don't huff glue.
Don't huff glue.
No, huff glue.
No, Robbie. Stop it, right? You're gonna get banned.
It's fun.
Well,
don't end up like Robbie.
Don't end up like me.
Oh, don't get any advice from Robbie.
Oh, gosh, no. I'm sorry to all the younger viewers out there.
Yeah, I'm really sorry. You were never going to find out.
Just disregard that
it,
side of the screen.
Shield your eyes,
use
children.
His mic.
Amazing. Well done.
Sing the song quick.
What was it? Rocky Road. In the merry month of June. That feels right.
Yeah.
Ready?
We talk about cocaine.
Let's attempt. So try and follow what vaguely me and Andy do these days now, because I'm not changing anymore. Yeah. I got a friend. In the merry month of June,
from me home I started, left the girls a tomb so sad and broken hearted, saluted father dear, a kiss my darling mother, drank a pint of beer, me grief and tears to smother, then off to reap the corn, leave where I was born, curl a stout like thorn to banish ghosts and goblin fun, new pair of brogs, rattling all the bogs, frightening all the dogs, on the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hop to hare and turn her down the rocky road, and all the ways to Dublin, whack for lolly ra. In the guard that night I rested, limbs so weary, started by delight, my spirit's bright and cheery, took a drop of the pure to keep my heart from sinking, that's the Paddy's cure, whenever he's on the drinking, to see the lassie smile, laughing all the while, at me curious sour, set your heart a-bubbling, asked if I was hired, wages I required till I was almost tired, on the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hut the hare and turn her down the rocky road, and all the ways to Dublin, whack for lolly ra. In Dublin next arrived, I thought it such a pity to be so soon deprived of view of that fine city. Then I took a stroll down among the quality bundle, it was stolen in a neat locality. Something crossed my mind when I looked behind the bundle, could I find a bum, a stick, a wobble, inquiring for the road, said me car it broke, wasn't much in vogue. On the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up the hare and turn her down the rocky road, and all the ways to Dublin, whack for lolly ra. From there I got away, my spirits never failing, landed on the quay just as the ship was sailing, captain at me roared, said there no room had he, and I jumped aboard a cabin bound for Paddy, was down among the pigs, played some hearty rigs, danced some hearty jigs, the water round me bubbling off to Holyhead, wished myself was dead or better for instead, on the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up the hare and turn her down the rocky road, and all the ways to Dublin, whack for lolly ra. The boys at Liverpool, when we safely landed, called myself a fool, I could no longer stand it, blood began to boil, the temper I was losing, poor old Erin's idol, they began abusing her arm, so says I, shillelagh, I'd a fly, some Galway boys are by, and so I was a hobbling with a loud hooray, joining me the fray, we quickly cleared the way, oh the rocky road to Dublin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to here and turn her down the rocky road, and all the ways to Dublin, whack for lolly ra.
Work for lolly ra.
That was great.
Work for lolly ra.
The perfect new ending. There we go.
Yeah.
Drop some funk on it. Is that the
sound that funk makes when you rub it into something?
Whack for lolly.
It's a squeaky sort of
yeah.
Yeah.
Window wiping.
Yeah, that kind of thing.
On the glass.
Oh man, I definitely need
well,
some air and a drink after that.
I think I'll go for a lie down.
Oh boy.
Mm.
Yeah, still haven't quite figured
it's,
that
it's
one
close.
Out.
It's close, definitely close.
Probably. It's getting there.
Sure.
Add that to the list of things to do and finish off at some point soon. Oh, I got some more questions. Let's do some more questions. And Dave's going to read any donations. If you missed it earlier, all the donations and stuff do count towards all the songs in the song list, which you can check in the link in the description. It'll probably appear in the chat in a second as well. They all get totaled up by Mr. Dave, and the messages and stuff that come with them get read out by Mr. Dave as well. So, Mr. Dave, sir.
Hi.
I should definitely stop calling you that. I heard something about emails being sent when the packages for the pre-orders were sent. Does everyone get an email when the package is sent out? Would be useful to know. I'm not sure how many we've been marking, but I can tell you with confidence right now, everything that doesn't include vinyl has been sent at this point.
Hooray!
So only the things which do include a vinyl have not been sent, because the vinyls have been delayed. But I thought it was still going to be possibly a few more weeks, but apparently it could be any time from this week that they'll be arriving with us. Over like the next 2 weeks, in theory.
Yeah, it's exciting times.
It's exciting times. So hopefully it won't be too much longer before we can send those off. Mm. But yeah, so some of them were only sent earlier this week. So if it's overseas from us, then still give it at least, I would say, 2 weeks before letting us know. Just because, yeah, it's taking a long time for stuff to get posted all over the place at the moment. So some things have been arriving overseas within a few days. Some take up to 2 weeks. So yes, but if it doesn't include a vinyl, then it should already be on its way to you. So if that is you, much excite, and I can't wait to see it. And when you do get it, please do take pictures and send it to us on like Instagram, Twitter, or whatever, because I love seeing them, and generally we retweet them and stuff as well. So it's nice to share the love and the joy of you guys receiving them too. So even the special edition shirts and hoodies have been sent out now too, mm-hmm. which is very cool. I'm still waiting to claim my special edition shirt, just in case any go missing in the post or anything. Yeah. So, because we have made as many as we need with like one spare. So we'll see. We'll see what happens.
Really hope those don't go missing in the mail.
Yeah.
Bad.
In theory, it should be right. They've been pretty good so far. And here's a question which we get asked a fair bit. When did y'all start singing? In fact, we could answer this differently. When did we actually start singing? When did you thinking of yourself as a singer?
Yelling for quite a while.
Last Tuesday?
when I started singing
and when I thought of myself as a singer, two very different questions.
Yeah,
me too, really.
Go for it.
I guess. I mean, it's, all right, who's starting?
I've been singing since I was like 2.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I've been.
All kids sing.
Yeah, I've been pretty much singing my whole life too. I was in like choirs at school and stuff, so it's always been something I've very naturally been able to do. I never really had to learn how to sing. And then
Joseph in primary school.
I was just always interested in music, really, so I started learning instruments.
I was Levi in Joseph.
Learning guitar.
My only line was to say, Levi!
But you had a name.
I had a name.
That's important.
That is useful.
I played the priest in Les Miserables in school.
Priest?
Yeah. And then I thought, I must be singing, because they put me on stage to make me do it, so...
Robbed in like the first scene and then you're not in it for the rest of it.
I get robbed, but I catch him and I have to basically say like,
"Oi,
because I'm a priest, I have to have this face. My son, you may go," or something to that effect, "but never steal again, if you know what's best for you."
Fantastic. I started singing when I was like, well, actually just singing at all, when I was like 15, 16? No, possibly even after that. No, I would have been about 16, I'll say. Listening to Jack Johnson.
Thanks, Jack Johnson.
Thanks, Jack Johnson.
For giving us a bass.
Yeah.
What guy? Still love him. What a legend. He's a really cool guy. He still does like loads of like charity fundraising sort of stuff, and he's very big on environmental charities and awareness and fundraising things. He's a cool dude. Very good.
Good. Has he had a hit since... that one song?
Have we had a hit?
We perhaps not. I don't hear him talking about us.
It was like 2 or 3 of his songs that were big.
They were big, yeah, sure. There's loads of good ones.
The way you're saying it doesn't convince me, Dave.
Yeah.
If people are allowed to have different music tastes.
I'm grateful for Jack Johnson.
I'm very glad, JD.
I'm passively grateful for Jack Johnson. Because he's given us you.
Thanks, Andy. That's sweet. Were there any more donations?
Yes. Breaker says, "Happy birthday and Kraken Hugs to Speedy. Their song choice."
Woo! Well, Speedy's choice.
Yeah, so Speedy, let me know. Mark van der Gracht says, "I don't have a heartfelt message or a lot of money to donate, but I want to say how much I love smoking my tobacco pipe while listening to your shanties."
Fantastic.
That's the best way to do it.
Well, when else are you going to smoke a tobacco pipe?
Exactly. I mean... when listening to folk music. C. Kyle says, "Oak and Ash and Thorn." And Classic Flannel says, "Chip it in for Off to Sea."
He didn't notice, it's fine.
I was staring blankly into the.
Yeah, that's a thing. A little bit. That's fine. I won't draw attention to it.
Speedy chooses lowlands.
Yeah.
It's super effective.
Maybe we can make a sea shanty trading card game.
I was going to do top trumps. As like a. While people are waiting for the board game, we're like, here's some top trumps. Have these instead.
I'm going to skip a couple of questions just to ask this one because it's fun. What socks is Dave wearing? They look interesting.
I think they're toucans.
They're toucans.
I thought it was a pineapple.
No, it's definitely a bird.
It is a toucan, yeah.
What pineapples have you seen?
I saw like a pineapple with a thing sticking out of it.
It's not like a dark black shadow pineapple.
Shadow pineapple. Anathema's also donating for Speedy's Choice. So I'll put that on Lowlands as well.
Great. Aww. Big love. All the love. What have we been doing?
I've got a lot of love to give tonight, Jake.
I've got all the love. I'm so full.
You said love like about 50 times.
I know, and I'm going to keep on saying
it. What else do you love,
Jake? Just until you get lamp through to me.
I love lamp. I wish you could show it off. It's got like a really cool bulb in it, but never mind.
You have to turn it off to be able to see that.
What was I going to say? Oh, I was going to say, what were we up to this month, this last month? Since we last saw people, what have
we
done? We
filmed a pretty cool video.
We did.
We filmed a very cool video.
Super cool video.
And I'm not going to tell you anything about it.
No. Well,
we did post a little mini picture.
I put a spoiler in Discord. Didn't tell anybody what it was.
Nope. The spoiler is in... Is it back here?
No.
It is back here.
Don't.
I should spoil my laptop's not a spoiler
Secrets.
Right now.
Is it?
Yeah.
No, right.
Oh. No, it's not.
Yeah, well,
not really.
It's a very, very loose spoiler.
Okay, yeah, I see what you're getting at. Very clever.
Subtly put spoilers everywhere in the room.
We actually like put some planning and things into making a pretty banging video. So it's the most effort we've probably put into making a video.
Probably, yeah.
And I'm very excited to get that out at some point soon. What else have we been up to? We've not really done too much here. Oh, we recorded some vocals for a track. Like a medley, a pop medley.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Yes, we did.
We absolutely did. That's going to be happening soon. I still need to send those over, actually. Did you upload them earlier today?
Yeah, they're in the...
Great, so I need to upload
those. We also recorded a set for Shrewsbury.
We did, that's right. Yeah. That. In fact, there's a few things we recorded for.
Vegisac, I think, as well.
Yeah, so Bremen Vegisac.
Which is next week?
Yes. So the festival we were going to be...
Vegisac next week?
It's going to be 2 weeks, I think. We were going to be singing at a festival in Germany, but they're now doing virtual stuff, so we sent them some recordings. So look out for that if you want to see us appearing with them, alongside a bunch of other fantastic groups as well. And yeah, we recorded a whole set for Shrewsbury Folk Festival as well, which is...
Shrewsbury.
Which is going to be happening in August as well, I think towards the end of August. So watch out for that too if you want to see us like playing songs and singing things in a bit more of a formal fashion of sorts. We recorded it on like the hottest day.
Yeah, we were right here where we're sitting now.
We were. Well, it was spread around the room a bit. But that was a crazy hot day.
It was very warm.
We're just melting in here a little bit. But
trying to social distancing whilst doing a gig in this room.
with it being very hot.
It was like one of the
with
hottest
the double
days
bass.
Of the year. Yeah,
it was
yeah.
mad. Absolutely mad. But really good fun. And in terms of videos and stuff, if you haven't seen them yet, we put out some pretty cool videos this last month. Oaken Ash and Thorn in yon forest. Which is pretty mega. I had a lot of fun playing with the colours on that, making it look all fantasy, weird, spooky forest madness. And we also did a 360-degree video of Wellerman, which is pretty good fun too. And hopefully we're going to do some more of that sort of thing at some point as well, finding some cool places to go and letting you guys experience the location with us as well whilst we're singing the song for you.
We've had a few forests now, so maybe we'll avoid the forest for a couple of videos.
No.
I feel like Banks of the Lee was foresty.
Actually,
it was very forest.
Oaken
Ash and Thorn was very forest.
And Rufford.
They're
all different forests.
They're all different forests. They're all different forests.
We need to do more wet.
That's what bands do. Film videos in forests.
We've done two on like beach cliff areas.
Yeah.
We've never had a really dark druidic kind of.
Oh, we've got plans for one.
We did one in the shed.
We did one at night.
We did one in the shed. Yeah,
dark
we did.
And druid.
We did one at night around a fire outside the studio.
Oh, we did.
Christmas at sea.
Yeah, that was quite good.
That was good fun.
Where can we go next, chat?
Ooh.
Where should we go? The longest John's film video on a yacht.
It's let's just spin a globe. Forest level, water level, dungeon level, lava level, ice level.
Sewer level.
Sewer level.
Let's skip that one.
There's
ice. We do want an ice.
Beer Emporium is technically in the old sewers.
Fair.
Just fair. I think I don't want to put that on Beer Emporium. Yes, we set up in a sewer.
Yeah. It's nice down there, though. Yeah, it looks more like a railway tunnel than a sewer. But either way. Right, shall we song?
You want a song?
Yeah, good
is
idea.
It Moby Duck?
Song title modified. No, that's not right. Well, how have you done that?
Has it freaked out?
It has.
Uh-oh.
How have I done that?
We haven't tuned to the note yet, so it's still anybody's game.
How is that?
Classic Flannel. What a great name.
Moby Duck system.
I don't understand what I've done, but it's Lowlands.
Oh. That's really good. You sure?
Oh, Classic Flannel is ska punk.
Oh, great.
But yeah, it's Lowlands. I don't know how I've managed to move stuff on this.
Lowlands, great. Who leads that?
I think it was you.
I think it's you, Robin.
It used to be you.
Yeah. I think you're the one that's done it the most.
I think I used to do it. Someone kind of. I'll do it.
I believe. If you're not sure what the words are and stuff, Lowlands for Speedy, absolutely. This is a happy birthday Speedy song. If you want to follow along with the lyrics and everything, I'm going to say that for this one, even though I'm not actually sure it's on there. All the lyrics for all the different songs that we are doing are available on thelongestsong.fandom.com, which was very lovingly put together by the mod Anathema, the wonderful person they are. And yes, it's got all the lyrics that we use for all the songs. If you want to find the ones that we actually sing along to and join in yourselves, or just read through and kind of learn about the songs, it's got all their information. Although Anathema is also sharing all of the information in chat too, so be educated with the joy that is learning about all the different songs. But yeah, if you want to find them, go onto that website and come join in. Enjoy. See what we're singing.
Where's a good place?
Dream the dream.
Lowlands away, my John.
All right?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go.
Is anyone going to go above Robbie?
No. Maybe. Depends on how high he can get to sit.
Lowlands away. I'll be up there.
Can do.
None of it's there.
Huh?
I can do it lower.
Well, I can go up there if you want. If someone else wants to be bass for a turn.
Go up there if you want.
Yeah? Do you want to be bass?
Yeah.
Dave's bass this time.
I don't remember what I normally do for this.
I'm going to do it down there.
Come back to me once we start.
I dreamed a dream the other night. Lowlands, lowlands away, my John. I dreamed a dream the other night. Lowlands away. I dreamt my love came in my sleep. Lowlands, lowlands away, my John. Her cheeks were wet, her eyes did weep. Lowlands away, she came to me at my bedside. Lowlands, lowlands away, my John. All dressed in white like some fair bride. Lowlands away, and bravely in her bosom fair. Lowlands, lowlands away, my John. A red, red rose my love did wear. Lowlands away, she made no sound, no word
she said. Lowlands, lowlands away, my John. And then I knew my love was dead. Lowlands away. Then I awoke to hear the cry. Lowlands, lowlands away, my John. Oh, watch on deck, oh, watch ahoy. Lowlands away.
About to be at the end there. Sorry,
quite. Away.
About away.
That was fun.
Ruined a very sensitive
Yay.
Song.
Singing high.
Yep.
Good times.
Well, I've never used at least three of those verses before, so...
Great.
That's good. It's nice to learn new verses off
yeah,
our lyrics
we
website.
Happy days.
Donations! Sangay says, Moby Duck, please. Also, how do you like grog or rum? I like them well.
Well, I have to admit, I'm not a huge rum fan. I know that might be controversial as a shanty singer and...
It's not my favourite liquor.
Pirate dude.
It's good, but it's not my favourite liquor.
I like rum a lot.
It's no scotch.
Dark rum that has a natural spice, not like spiced rum that's mega sweet and overpowering.
Dark rum is good.
Kraken dark rum is amazing.
Yeah.
I do love that. That's the one that's
still quite sweet though.
It is. That stands out to me as like... That's the good one.
Alexander Charters says Moby Duck is it's one of my favourites.
Yeah.
Ortiz says retroactive thanks for Andy's goat version of Troubles. I assume you know what that means.
No idea.
Have you performed Troubles as one of your streams?
I perform it a lot, but I haven't.
There you go. The goat version.
What do you mean?
It's capitalised like it's an acronym.
I don't know what that means.
But I don't know. All or not also. Gave money for Speedies. John Clayton became a wide John. And Classic Flannel said the channel formerly known as Ska Punk must not be outbid. Off to see.
Amazing. I just want to give a quick mention about the donation system again, because I saw some confusion popping up in chat. I think it's possibly been answered by the mods, but just in case anyone else is confused as well, the numbers that you're seeing below aren't the prices for those songs. That may be confusing if you're the first time watching. Those are the current running totals donated towards those songs. So all the donations that you're seeing pop up, either with the tips thing using the link that's below, or Super Chat in the actual chat for YouTube as well, all those things are being totaled up towards those songs by Dave over in the corner. Mm-hmm. And then it's just the top five that are being run across the bottom. So you can see kind of currently what's at the top and therefore what... in theory, is going to be sung next.
I'm being told that GOAT stands for Greatest of All Time.
There we go. I thought it was an Overwatch thing.
GOAT.
I thought it was just a GOAT version.
That's what my mind was going to as well, because it's a thing in Overwatch, but I was like, it's probably not related.
It was an Overwatch thing.
Or they just want like the GOAT version. Well, that GOAT was doing it. It was like, oh, the GOAT version of Taylor Swift, or the GOAT version of the other pop song. With the goat making a loud noise. Like,
goats are just the best.
the
noises that come out of them is just hilarious.
I wouldn't say they're the best
animal. This is a long, drawn out...
They're not the best animal, no.
Drawn out...
What are they the best of?
They're just hilarious.
What was that animal you really liked at that random like oasis place we went to at that festival? Remember we went to like an animal oasis or something and you were like, that thing.
Margay.
Yeah, a little cat kind of.
Oh, yeah, we never saw them.
The tree ocelot.
Yeah.
Tree ocelot.
That we saw its picture and it had massive eyes and it was mega cute.
Incredibly adorable.
And we didn't get to see it.
We didn't see it because it's nocturnal.
We hung out with some monkeys though. We gave them sticks.
Yeah, they loved those sticks.
Yeah. And just sitting there weaving them. I get the same reactions and stuff out of Joey now. He just like grabs for things and then like, mouth.
Yes. So you know what something is, you grab it and put it in your mouth.
Pretty much. It's a good way of telling. It's also a quick way to learn never to do that again if it goes wrong.
Good times. Any more questions? Let's do some questions. That's always fun. That's the thing that I like to do and read. Where did I get to? Hey guys, hope you're doing. Hope you're having a good day. How's the youngest John doing? He's doing all right. He's in bed at the moment. He's had some walkies and adventures today, which is cool.
Walkies.
He had some nice time smiling at you guys earlier.
Smiling. He's,
well, he was very tired. He does do cute blinkies.
He looks at you in this sort of constant double take kind of way.
Have you seen this picture on my phone? He's like.
Yeah, I did.
That is
very adorable.
I
haven't seen it in real life yet.
That is a cheeky face.
It's such a cheeky.
Yes, I believe that happened.
But yeah, he's doing well, bless him. Renaissance Fair asked about that.
Do you see anything? Is there anything he does that, like, oh, that's me? Yeah.
No.
Nothing. 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 You just like.
No, not particularly. I mean, it'll get there, I'm sure.
Yeah.
But I've not particularly noticed. I mean, possibly the grin, like the cheek.
That one.
Maybe, but there we go. This is something we were actually chatting about earlier. Will you guys be reselling the CD that has Captain's Daughter on again? Which is Bones in the Ocean EP.
Yeah, it keeps coming up.
We were talking about it earlier, and possibly is the most accurate answer at the moment.
I mean, the easiest way is to buy or listen to it online.
Yeah, you can
definitely still
download it.
For download.
But we're discussing what best to do about the CD. Because the actual sound of it, I'm not even sure if we've got the original files still somewhere.
And no one uses CDs.
Loads of people. If the website's anything to go by, loads of people do.
People are buying them to put them in frames on the wall. They're not using the CDs.
It's just a nice shiny coaster.
There we go.
Ward off birds from your garden.
But yeah, we'll see. We'll see what the plan is with that. But yes. Because we've got some ideas. But it's a bit old and not really representative of our sound now, but it's already there, so we'll see. We'll let you know down the line. But currently, CD is not available. It's only available digitally. What's been your favourite song to record, or that we've recorded, rather?
Huh.
Ooh, I kind of like answering that as favourite song to record.
What?
What? Are we recording them all?
Favourite song that we've recorded, it's just like, what's the best song? Kind of thing, but what's your favourite song to record? Is
the
what
one
was...
we had the one we had most fun recording?
Yeah,
sure. That's the question.
I don't think it was, but that's kind of the question I want to answer. So I'm going to go with that.
You do you, mate.
Well, what would you say?
Well, I would say Moby Duck was really fun.
That was really fun.
That was fun.
Pretty fun.
Doing that on like the extra day as well.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah,
I enjoyed that.
So we got all the drums down, and I think sort of a guide vocal first. So they spent the rest of the days trying to play along to.
There's a clip in the behind the scenes of you three dancing to
yes,
and waiting for the
that was actually the recorded take that we used on the track, and it's just us prattling around and then occasionally singing
right,
the parts.
The song is basically prattling around. That was a perfect feel, I thought.
It was perfect.
I think I had the most fun recording that.
And then
it was
the
kind of like,
around.
Is this drum beat funnier than this drum beat?
Yeah.
I agree. Pretty much.
Which is more like a duck.
It's a serious musical that
The trumpet.
Yeah, that was
fun.
The
most duck-sounding instruments we can use on this.
I wish we could have been there when Love was recording that, because that was amazing. I think I would probably go with that as well. That was pretty, pretty good fun. One more question, and then onwards.
Sam's saying that shirt is the only t-shirt you own, JD.
It's the only t-shirt.
every stream with video comments. Is that a comment or digital shirt?
That's why he wears it, chat. That's why he wears it, chat.
It's no, I just really like the shirt. I've got like 5 or 6 shirts in rotation at the moment, which I just
JD
really
feeds
enjoy.
Off the "Is that a current or digital t-shirt" comments. That's how he gains power.
Well,
like a vampire.
I keep wearing all of our t-shirts, and then this one is like in between, and then usually they're kind of clean again by the time it comes back around. So this is very much in the rotation of limited shirts. So there we go. Love the D20 from your merchandise. Who's the gamer?
Everyone but Robbie.
Well,
you have a life.
You have your moments.
What?
You have your moments. You have.
I like some games.
You dabble.
You
play D&D.
Who doesn't like some games?
He's not a true gamer.
What does everyone do with their time?
I assume they meant tabletop role-playing games, not games.
Robbie played D&D with us once.
Yeah.
It was a session that didn't really work. We had too many players.
It was
players,
pretty funny, though.
And I was still kind of learning how to DM.
I mean, I probably got the wrong kind of, picked the wrong night for it, I think. But I don't know, I could probably be convinced to give it a crack again.
I think in the last few years, I've bought like 5 times the amount of dice than times I've actually played the game.
Yeah.
It's so good.
I like having dice that I only rarely get to play.
Getting the D20s when they came through was magic. We were all here at the time, actually, as well, weren't we? Mm. That was really cool.
It like, will be on a future
vlog. It will.
Or in a couple of weeks, I believe, it's scheduled.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's fun having all the dice and stuff and all the paraphernalia.
It's really fun.
The collectible, isn't it? I have Pokemon cards at one point. I don't see it as too much.
We've got a 3D printer now, like a fancy, really high detail resin 3D printer. So
I still have my Pokemon cards. So
I was going to say, we might look at trying to make some more stuff using that for merchy things down the line. So who knows?
Ooh.
Who knows? It's definitely considerations. One at a time.
Slowly churning out dice.
No, with that, you can do an entire.
You see the waiting time long on the vinyl. Ooh, you wait.
Would people order 100 a day and then you set the printer going? It'll be done in 6 months.
Yeah, pretty much. I've just seen a question in chat, actually, which I think we should answer anyway. What are your guys' names from left to right? So starting with you.
Hang on.
I think most of our names are left to right.
E-V-A-D.
Evad.
No, I'm reversed on screen.
Oh, you're mirroring it.
So it's Evad.
Clever.
Okay, Dave.
But either way, it's Robbie first.
Sure.
I've just spoiled it.
Dave just...
Eidor! Change. Eidor the Magnificent.
Mine sounds sort of...
DJ!
Well, if you go full name, Nartanodge.
Nartanodge.
Mine is like...
It's like, what is your troll name? Your name backwards, please.
Idna.
What?
Idna.
And
Idna.
Wordner.
It's
just Wordner.
Wordner. Andrew Yates.
Oh, Andrew. Alright, let's do it, Andy.
Oh. Wordner.
Wordner.
I like Wordner better. Wordner. Satay, would anybody like a Satay Wordner? that's my name backwards.
Andy's brand of nibbles.
Old band that I was in this evening did nickname me King Prawn because John Darley, if you say John Darley, sounds kind of like a curry.
Just a little bit, yeah.
King Prawn, Jean Darley.
Pint of lager, yeah, that works. I like it.
So there we go.
Yeah, serious answer: Robbie, JD, Andy, Dave.
Yes,
that's the easy
way
to do it.
Yeah, why would we
got a bit carried away there for a second.
This is Robbie.
Good times
here
for our own explanation.
This is JD.
I'm
Andy.
JD on the head.
Just Dave.
Yay! Right, song.
Lovely to meet you.
Song.
Do you want a guitar, JD?
I'd love a guitar.
Then go off to sea.
Okay, I need that guitar.
Oh,
this one.
Yeah.
This wasn't part of the contract.
Oh, reveal how close Robbie is to you by the pass.
Oh no, it's contaminated.
Maximum length.
Oh no. Oh no, I have to cut my hand off.
No, we have to amputate the guitar.
That'll
now.
Share more bodily fluids. We don't want that.
Oh no.
I'll put a tourniquet on it. Fine. Keep my spray to a minimum.
Please never say that again.
I've slowly worked out all the things that I can't say over a few streams.
By then our channel will be banned.
Can't say splurt all over the place. What has this world come to? Yeah, let's just start the song.
When first I landed in Liverpool, I went the spree. With money at last I spent it fast. I got drunk as drunk could be. But when my money was all gone, it was then that I wanted more. But a man must be blind to make up his mind to go to sea once more. Once more, once more. Go to sea once more. But a man must be blind to make up his mind to go to sea once more. So as I walked down London Road, I met with a rapper Brown. I asked him if he'd take me in, and he looked at me with a frown. He said, last time you was paid off, to me a chalk's no score, but I'll give you a chance, and I'll take your advance, and I'll send you to sea once more. Once more, once more, send you to sea once more. Well, I'll give you a chance, and I'll take your advance, and I'll send you to sea once more. I shipped on board of a whaling bark, we were bound for the Greenland seas. When cold winds blow through frost and snow, why Jamaica rum would freeze. To bear, I'd no hard weather gear, as I'd spent all my money ashore. It was then that I wished that I was dead and could go to sea no more. No more, no more, go to sea no more. It was then that I wished that I was dead and could go to sea. Sometimes we're catching whales, my lads, and sometimes we're catching none. With a 20-foot oar stuck in your paw from 4 o'clock in the morn. And as the shades of night roll on and you rest on your weary oar, it was then that I wished that I was dead and could go to sea. I was dead and could go to sea no more. So come all of you hard weather sailing lads who listen to my song. When you get back from those long trips, I'd have you not go wrong. Take my advice, drink no strong drink, don't you knock on that brothel door, but get married instead, and spend all night in bed, and go to sea no more. No more, no more, go to sea no more, but get married instead, and spend all night in bed, and go to sea no more. No more, no more, go to sea no more, but get married instead, and spend all night in bed, and go to sea no
right at the end. So close.
Yeah. No more.
No more.
No more, no more of that. More.
Was that, were we calling anathema a bot?
Yeah.
A
yeah, anathema
bot. Oh.
Some impressive general knowledge going on there, though.
Yeah. Anathema knows all.
You know more than I do. By like a considerable way.
Yeah.
Anathema has put many more hours of research in than all of us put together.
Yeah, we learn the songs. Anathema researches the songs for us.
We learn off the website with all of the info. Yeah. Like.
Amazing.
There's info on our wiki about songs that we wrote that we didn't know.
Yeah, I didn't know either. I saw the Ashes one the other day. I was like, I think so.
Yeah,
that's right. Yeah. Makes sense.
Oh, that's an amusing question. Can we review the shanties from AC Black Flag?
Review
them.
Middling to poor.
Make it like I mean, that goes Black Flag Sea Shanty's tier list of just like.
I think after, I mean, going, after going through them to some fairly extreme degree, they are.
Yeah, not the shanties themselves, the recordings on Black Flag.
Some of them are some of them are really great.
Some of them are brilliant.
Very wild.
They're very atmospheric.
They're very some of them are very true character. To the form.
Yeah. Yeah. There's definitely one or two which from closely inspecting them and looking at trying to learn them are just like so out of tune. Like it's impossible to even find the like original melody sometimes because it's like changing all over the place.
Imagine what the sheet music would look like, can't you?
Yeah.
In the context of the game, that's fine.
Oh, it's fantastic. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It sounds amazing in the game. And they are really like full of character and really enjoyable to listen to because of that. But for us to kind of come in and try and sing over the top of them.
We're quite a melodic and tuneful.
Yes.
Tuneful
group. We want to kind of capture the energy and excitement and the atmosphere of that. But
make
with
pleasant harmonies
with a really lovely sound as well.
Yeah. With no work involved. minimal work.
Just make it sound good.
But no, there's some really great tunes. There are some really good ones on the soundtrack.
There
I really
are
like
brilliant
the,
ones.
The recordings off.
Well, I used to, like ages ago, just listen to it when driving around places. I mean, we did actually, to be fair, when we were traveling, we used to put them on and sing on to them all the time when we were going to gigs.
Yeah.
So
it was a good place to kind of start looking for new songs as well to sing if you kind of run out of material.
There's actually a few on there which we've never touched which are actually really good.
Mm-hmm.
We were listening to earlier today actually.
Yeah.
Someone
else did all the research, like we'll just pick and choose. That's how it works.
Oh dear. Shocking. This is a fun question. What's the most complicated song you've written?
Complicated like?
I tend to put too many syllables or words.
I think it's nice. Yeah.
Words
Moby Ducks or Got New Beard.
Ooh.
I think probably Moby Duck.
I once met a man all big and broad with an eye patch parrot and a long curved sword.
That's a high level verse.
I once met a man all big and broad with an eye patch parrot and a long curved sword.
I had just like about it.
Just like about it.
No room for breaths at all. I've written songs and then tried to sing them and go, there's no time for breathing in this.
Yeah.
Can't hold a drink if you can't hold your drink.
Yeah.
Yeah,
like,
that was a tough one.
What about musically? I reckon the musically most complicated one we've done is
Moby Duck. Just with the key.
Oh, the Moby Duck with the major minor.
That was
hard
with
when we were doing it
well.
A cappella.
Yeah.
It was easier once we put instruments in.
I think in terms of straight guitar parts, I would say that the thing I do for Sam Hall is probably the most complicated. The album, probably Bonnie. Because it's got like twiddly bits, which is fun to play.
Only you know.
There you go.
All the harmonium parts of some of them are kind of mostly just kind of root and fifth for a lot of stuff because I can't physically fit my fingers around these tiny keys.
Really?
So yeah, I just sort of simplify it. It's trying to move
sausage
from
fingers.
One chord to the next. Especially if it's like a D where you're in the middle of two. Like, look at that. If I try and run a D down, I'm pressing C sharp and D sharp in with it.
Fantastic.
The banjo parts are all quite easy. They're just in awkward keys.
There are some weird chords and stuff we throw in things. Like, Councillor B's asking, did we write the harmonies for Banks of the Lee? Yes.
Yes, we did. We didn't write the tune, but we wrote the harmonies.
We generally... It's like a vague idea of what the songs actually sound like when we try and learn them. And then we just kind of come up with our own things around it. Like the chords and
like,
stuff with that
yeah,
we added
like,
in. There's some new ones we definitely threw in.
Because we listened to John Bromley from Kimber's Men sing it.
With no harmonies.
And I couldn't find any other versions with a cappella harmonies at all. I don't think. I personally couldn't find any. They might be out there, but yeah. So we came up
pretty
with some
much.
Cool stuff.
Yeah, I'd say pretty much we come up with our own for things. There's ones where they're definitely based
inspired,
on other people's ones, where we've listened to it. And then like done our own thing off the back of it, but we've never specifically gone. Oh, what did that person sing? Oh, I need to change what I'm doing so I can sing what they sang. It's always just like we do our own thing.
What's the pity in some cases? I think it gives us our own slant on things.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I think the main thing we've done that's very close to somebody else's arrangement is Rufford Park Poachers, really.
Yeah, in terms of like actual arrangement and everything.
Polly on the Shore as well. Unfortunately, they were by the same people.
Yes, because their arrangements are really good.
Because their arrangements were
pretty,
not going to get any better.
Pretty top notch. Speaking of Oxygen, the door is open. Don't you fear. fear thee not. We have the aircon and the door open, but there is like a thing in front of the door, so...
Is somebody keeping a tab on the amount of time we've spent without oxygen?
Oh, it's just the friendly reminder that if the door's not open, it gets...
Oh, right.
It gets angry in here.
Oh, right, I thought someone on chat was...
This is your like, friendly reminder to bring the oxygen.
Pretty much, I mean, in a good way.
Nice. Staff revenue.
Got any more donation reads?
Yes. Romina says, it's my birthday in 2 hours.
Oh,
this was 20 minutes ago.
Hour and a half then.
I would love to hear Crossing the Bar before the night is over. It's been one of my favourites since hearing it live at Festival Maritim in Bremen 2 years ago.
Ooh, nice.
Thank you for your wonderful music. All the best from Germany. John Clayton, Moby Duck for the win.
Woo!
My son Zach's favourite.
Yeah, we've been putting off Moby Duck long enough. I think we better do that.
My son
Northamptonian Knight says, we're on the railroad. What's the most complicated song you've written? We just answered that.
Oh, yeah, we did.
Also, video idea, Reed Cutter's Daughter, filmed by a brook.
Oh, that is such a good song, but I'm not sure.
I feel bad taking it away from Jimmy and Sid.
Jimmy and Sid,
it's kind of theirs.
Did it so well.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how it can be improved on, to be perfectly honest.
Big Tex became a member.
I mean, we don't necessarily learn songs because we think we can improve on them, but just because we want to do them. But
yeah,
that song is, it's so good when they do it. Ugh.
Also, question for Andy from Spaceman.
Yes.
Can you sing Vatican Rag? If not, Old Triangle.
Okay.
Do you want to do Vatican Rag?
I can do it if everybody wants to.
I mean,
me
it would put it in second place if I added it.
We can just all take a break for a minute. And let
I don't mind singing that song.
Okay, we'll do Moby Duck and then Vatican Rag.
Okay.
And then we'll get back onto
it. It's very short. Vatican Rag is very short.
It is. Fine.
We'll all run to the loo while you do Vatican Rag on your own.
that's pretty funny. Oh, and Big Tex became a wide John.
Big Tex.
Yay. That's possibly a renewal.
Yeah, I remember
you had before.
Big Tex.
But that's really cool. Welcome back to being a wide John, Big Tex. Yeah, if anyone's confused by that, because we haven't mentioned it too much today, we have YouTube memberships on our channel, which is basically kind of like a Patreon sort of thing, or if you watch stuff on Twitch, like being a Twitch subscriber, where you can donate regularly towards a channel, which unlocks you all of our custom emotes in chat for all of the live streams. Also, all the amounts that your membership goes, or you pay into your membership, gets totaled up towards songs on all the live streams as well. So if you would normally like to donate 4 songs on here, then those also count towards them in the same way. So there you go, just another way of contributing regularly and supporting what we do. We're looking at trying to make some stuff specifically for members. We had some ideas and then we kind of changed our minds a little bit, so we're still working on it. But for now, all of that money goes towards songs on the live streams. So
we want to make something that's good and interesting for the members, but not so good that everyone else misses out by not seeing it.
Yeah.
Like, we thought about doing some 360 videos just for them, but after people really seem to enjoy the last one that we did, we might just do more of those for the main channel, to be honest. So
we'll do some slightly worse 360 videos.
Yeah. We'll stick it next to a wall, so it's just a 180 video. That'll do.
180 video.
Or like, put it on its side, so you can
just lying on the floor,
at the floor,
just looking at
the sky, and then you have to pan it around to a weird place to see.
Yeah, can we start doing 360 videos where we're only in 180, and then the other 180 is something a bit more interesting?
Yeah, 360 live stream. When we did actually do a little mini 360 live stream before our last,
like one song.
Yeah, we just did like one song on Facebook, which is good.
I think
fun.
It's too much. You wouldn't want to watch a whole live stream like that.
Well, the problem is, with that camera, there's not a way natively to hook up another microphone to it. So you're kind of stuck with just the mic that it has on it, which means you can't have the nice ones that we're using here. So the sound will definitely not be as good by a long way. That's the problem with doing lots. We'll definitely take it with us when we go traveling again and do like some little 360 streams and videos and that sort of thing when we're around in different festivals and cool places. But
when are we going to go traveling again, Uncle JD?
I don't know.
I've been in the house such an ever long time.
I'm sure you have, Robbie. Mm.
Right. Listen, should we duck it?
Is it ducking?
Oh, ducking.
Ducking time.
Right.
No, duck.
I'm just making him.
Oh, gosh. Can I have a candle?
Oh, yeah, you're going to...
Use the other one.
You're gonna try and drag yourself into frame. Can you be positioned behind Robbie on the screen, like in the middle? See what you can do.
Can I sit on the table?
Yeah?
Yeah, if you want.
That might work.
Just don't sit on a quacken.
Don't hit the camera.
It's going to be a bit low down. We're going to be stretching up.
Mm. Lie on the floor in front of the camera.
Move that just in case this all goes wrong. I'm probably going to be out of focus. And also possibly just being wrong. Oh yeah, this is great.
That's not too bad.
Nice.
Too loud now, just putting that out
there. Nah, definitely not.
Okay.
After 14 years, I left the sea for a life upon a lake. After all the storms I'd seen, I needed a good break. I thought still water would mean peace for me, but that was a mistake. For the place I chose was bedeviled by a giant evil drake, a mallard of such malice, twice the size of any man, a bill to give you nightmares and a monstrous wingspan. You cannot hope to fight it, so avoid him if you can, that terrifying waterfowl, the beast beyond the dam. Row, ho, row, ho, row with all your might, row with heart whose load is boiling for a fight. Row, ho, row, ho, and with any luck, we'll win the day and do away the dreaded moon. Surrender, so a vengeful oath I swore, and gathered up me hearties like so many times before. We shot our ship with weapons and prepared to go to war, till that pleasant feathered fearsome flying duck will breathe no more. Row, ho, row, ho, row with all our might, row with harpoons loaded and spoiling for a fight. Row, ho, row, ho, and with any luck we'll win the day and do away the dreaded Moby Duck. There was Bonnie Brave Marie, who to our arms and waved goodbye, and Handsome Jack, whose duck attack left him without an eye, and Darby twins on one leg, each on deck were standing by, only a couple of dozen limbs between a crew of 25. Row, ho, row, ho, row with all our might, row with harpoons loaded and spoiling for a fight. Row, ho, row, ho, and with any luck we'll win the day and do away the dreaded Moby Duck. The fight raged on for several hours, defend and then attack. With beatings from those wicked wings, our boat began to crack. The beast reared up to finish the job, and with a mighty quack, I rammed my harpoon in his throat and made a tasty snack. Row, ho, row, ho, row us back to shore. We'll drag his broken body back and roast it on an oar. Row, ho, row, ho, barbecue the beast. With hoisin sauce and pancakes, we will have the biggest feast. Oh, row, ho, row, ho, row with all our might. Row with harpoons loaded and spoiling for a fight. Row, ho, row, ho, we had all the luck. We won the day and did away the dreaded Moby Duck. We won the day and did away the dreaded Moby Duck.
Lovely. Yeah. See the trumpets in chat. Beautiful.
Oh dear. It's exciting.
The best bit of that though is the Oh, love it. Yeah.
That's
maximum duck right there.
Maximum duck.
In for a penny, in for a duck.
Break.
Fine stringy. Let's go to the screech. Little screeches.
Good stuff coming up.
What?
Some good stuff coming up. We've got rail
songs
and
yeah. Well, it's
Louise.
It's Vatican Rag, and then it's JD's choice.
Oh,
so get thinking.
Maximum duck.
I want to go to the loo, but I also want to hear Vatican Rag because I like it.
That is a fair. That is a difficult conundrum you have right now.
Do it, and then I'll
move over a little bit. You're kind of very much on this side of the table. This is how the Vatican Rag shall be.
Sorry, everybody.
Oh, yeah. I'm miles away from the mic. Thanks, Robbie.
Mic back.
Thanks, Robbie. Thanks, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Yeah. Do you want me to just do it now? I don't.
I mean, it's time.
Or
we only just had a song.
Do it.
All
right. Okay. This is a Tom Lehrer song. It's kind of a piss take of the Catholic Church.
Go for it.
I did get the words up.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be useful. I'm ready. Back to the creepy corn.
Once more.
So first you get down on your knees and fiddle with your rosaries. Bow your head with great respect and genuflect. Do whatever steps you want if you have cleared them with the pontiff. Everybody say his own Kyrie eleison, doing the Vatican rag. Get in line in that processional, step into that small confessional. There's a guy who's got religion, tell you if your sin's original. If it is, try playing it safer, drink the wine and chew the wafer. 2, 4, 6, 8, time to transubstantiate. Get down upon your knees and fiddle with your rosaries. Bow your head with great respect and genuflect. Make a cross on your abdomen when in Rome, do like a Roman. Ave Maria, geez, good to see ya. Getting ecstatic and so dramatic and doing the Vatican rag.
Yeah.
Tom Lehrer, everybody.
Larry.
Benson Adams, everyone. Became a white John.
Oh. I thought that's not Tom Lehrer.
Benson Adams, everybody. That's my stage name.
Yeah. Benson Adams.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like it's been taken. But yeah, thanks for coming away, John. Adequate. That was great. It is a fun song. It's very silly. Very fun. I am greatly enjoying these sweets.
Good.
Not going to lie. These are really good.
Well, as long as I can contribute something.
Yeah.
I didn't know they did Starburst in just berry.
There you go. I mean, these just like sour dummies are amazing.
Mm. Not bad, it's like all the best bits of Haribo.
Yeah. If it was cherry cola, even better. Well, that one actually was. That was really good. Mmm.
We can only strive for perfection.
Oh, that's a good sweet.
Excuse me.
That's a good sweet. Oh.
Yeah.
That's like really sour berries. Mmm. Mmm. I'm going in. Wow. You're probably getting all the chewing sounds coming through the mic. Sorry about that.
No.
Which is really good.
Yeah. Sorry or not sorry.
Was someone asking about totals and stuff for songs?
I'm not sure.
Yes. So Dave's just nipped out of the room. They won't be totaling out for a second just whilst he's out of the room because he does the totaling. But yes, if you're confused, all the songs underneath are the current running totals for those songs as they've been donated for. And if there are any that you would like to donate for, or especially want to hear, check the song list in the description below. And then, all the donations for those songs get totaled up. And it's currently the top 5 are just running across the bottom. There we go.
Woo.
Hopefully that clears up the confusion. There's a donation by Big Tex.
Big Tex, currently watching a shanty stream while on a boat in Minecraft.
Nice.
Yeah. How much do we need donated to get Jolly Rouge? I'll have a look.
What are the stocks,
Dave? This is the first donation for Jolly Rouge, so it's pretty low.
Bit of a ways, then. Great song. Longest John Sweets coming soon? No. What would they be? Just like anchor shaped? Quacking shaped?
Like so. Anchor, I mean, anchor gummies.
Anchor gummies.
I'd eat an anchor gummy.
They're very salty.
Oh,
yes, that's salty so sweets. Good.
Yeah, like yeah. Salt licorice.
What other flavor? What other flavors do you get on board ships?
Salty sweets could actually be quite amusing.
Like yeah. Ships biscuits.
Ships biscuits, biscuits flavored. No, they have to be gummy sweets. Just awful flavors. eels, eel flavored.
Gummy eels, delicious.
Possible ship diseases can we manage to create a flavour for?
Ah.
Scurvy flavour.
I'm going to put up one other thing as well, which Glip Whip has just raised, saying, Yishu, you like to put donations towards songs that aren't often sung, so many people donate for the more popular ones. Yours gets pushed to the bottom of the list and never gets sung. Well, in theory, the system we have for that should, in theory, mean it will get to the top at some point, because... You'll possibly see on the donations page for the song list that there's a multiplier next to the different songs. So as they get sung on consecutive streams, the donation totals get like a negative multiplier mm-hmm. applied to them. So like it just gives... Yeah, so it still means that song's getting donated for and totaled up and everything, but it means the ones that get sung on every single stream eventually kind of have a slightly harder time of reaching the top, basically. So it gives those less... commonly sung ones more of a chance to be able to get to the top.
Bottom of the modifier, currently Retirement Song and The Curse.
Yeah, what's their current total?
0.5 and 0.6.
Fair play. So yeah, there we go. So because we've sung them a lot, there's less chance for us to kind of keep doing it every single stream. They'll still obviously total up as people donate to them, that sort of thing. But yes, so that's the system we've got in place to total for it. So also, if you donate for a song and you think, wait a second, I put in $10 but it's only come up as $8, that sort of thing, that's the reason why. It's all being calculated maths wise and yeah, it was pretty much the fairest system we could devise so that people's donations count towards something every time, whilst giving the people who kind of want to hear something more obscure, that sort of thing, the chance to be able to get their things up there as well. So hopefully that makes sense to you. We tried a few different things. We tried just like for ages trying to just sing anything that people threw money at us for, but then there were loads that we couldn't do. There was loads of songs that we weren't very good at and that sort of thing. So
we had one specific stream I can remember very well.
You lost your mind on it.
Every single song we'd never played before, but someone gave us money, so we were like,
oh, I guess we should.
I guess we need to sing this now.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's all right. Then we got a chemical engineer on it and he sorted it out for us. Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So yeah, I hope that makes sense at least. Anyway, do you know what time it is?
It's all in an attempt to try and.
What time is it,
Eddie? It's
9:30.
Great. Good. Mm-hmm. Time to go home.
But in just a second, it's about to be 9:31. Do you know what happens at 9:31?
We go home.
Biscuits.
No. Oh, biscuits. Oh man.
Union mandated tea break.
Yeah. For the union. Let's strike. Is there a shanty union? I feel like there shouldn't be.
I mean,
the last shanty man died in sort
I don't think we need a shanty union.
No.
Maybe the what?
I mean, I'm in the musicians' union. That's probably the closest we've got
pretty
right
sure
now.
That covers it.
Yeah, that'll do. I'm waiting for it. I've committed. It's now 9:31, so do you know what time it is?
What time is it?
Location time. Everybody loves location time.
Whether you're in Australia or in X-Men Days of Future Past.
Everybody loves location time.
When you from?
It's a Hugh Jackman joke.
Because
he was in the film Australia.
Days of
Future Past.
Oh, that went right over my head.
Yeah.
I'm taking best. Over those.
You can do the next one, Robert. That's fine.
You have
but
clearly run your
house
dry.
If you don't know what location time is, we would love to see and read all the different places from around the world that you guys are watching from, because it's mad to see, and it's such a joy to kind of get to read all the different places. And Dave's going to do his best to try and keep up with chat as it's going.
Denmark, Margaret Harbour, Alaska, Harrogate, Idaho, Canada, Gothenburg, Haas Mountains, Kentucky, Canada, it's got faster, Finland, New York, Norwich, White, Sardinia, Rhode Island, Sweden, Berlin, Washington, Pennsylvania, Boston, Hertfordshire, Lithuania, Ottawa, Saudi Arabia, Hamburg, Under the Sofa,
Bridgewater, that's just down the road.
Mother.
No.
Somewhere between Liverpool and Wales. Oh, no, wait.
Too close.
Now you lost somewhere between Liverpool and Wales. Do you need help?
Washington, Sox, lads.
Coventry, Devon, Lincoln,
Montana, Michigan, Saudi Arabia,
Missouri, Maine,
Poland,
in Robbie's cap right behind me.
Oh, yeah.
Australia.
Normally 30 seconds of kind of vaguely truthful, as much as you're willing to say, and then do your best to make us laugh with your locations.
That one Welsh place with an extremely long name that no one can pronounce.
Wolfsburg,
the centre of the earth. 8 hours in the past.
8 hours in the past.
The Bermuda Triangle.
in the bowels of Reynard the Fox.
Reynard the Fox, what's that a reference to?
No idea. Cannon That's Cove.
Snaggly. Even not knowing, it sounds great.
Under Tibble. Oregon.
My mum's house.
Fighting Moby Duck. Right here. Wait.
That's Dave's chat's way ahead of mine. I've just seen 8 hours in the past pop up.
Why are you so far behind?
I don't know.
He did start repeating things David already said.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
On the Andouilles. Skyrim.
Wow.
On some mountain. In a box, or am I?
That's crazy. We got people on many different continents right now. I wonder how many different countries that is.
Zed is Schrodinger's cat.
Mmm.
On the Andouilles. Jurassic Park.
Huh.
Slacking at work.
Yeah.
I'm learning about Reynard the Fox.
I live in misery. Missouri.
I'm in misery. Oh.
Nice.
Okay.
Do you want to tell us, Andy?
It's just a medieval literary cycle, apparently. Lots of tales about Reynard the Fox and stuff.
Great.
Interesting.
I think I heard one of those. They had one in, like, a storytelling thing in Bristol.
Hung Disaster. Reynard the Fox is a trickster figure from medieval French English stories and mythology. He's really cool. Sounds great. I'm going to learn about that later.
Turbo Island?
Yeah.
That's that place where then people drink cider.
It is. In Light Brazil. Fires. And...
Yeah?
Yep.
Wake me up.
Wake me up. Do they really?
No, I used to when I lived opposite it.
Yeah. I've never seen anything interesting happen there.
I've only ever seen it completely blank or like packed every single square ridge with a person in it.
You want to wait until there's something that the news tells you you don't want to go anywhere near and then go. That's the best time to be there.
That's the time. But yeah, that's so cool. Thank you so much for the sharing that. As I say, super, super cool to see all the different countries and places that people are watching.
Mm. Who's furthest, do we think? Was there a New Zealand?
Australia. There was an Australia.
We have quite a few people who listen to us in Australia now, according to Spotify.
Yeah. Presumably there's people in New Zealand, since we've got this lovely wooden postcard.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Canada actually overtook the UK as our second most listened to country.
Nice.
The other day.
UK is our third.
Yes, UK is now third.
Come on, UK.
What have we done to ourselves?
It's like no one likes us around here.
Nah, we're moving to Canada.
Well, US is still by far number one.
Yeah, but
it's like US, then Canada, and then UK.
Are you sure you weren't reading it wrong? It's actually us that listens to us the most.
Got it. Shame. Ding, ding. That's pretty cool. I'm all for it. I'd love to go to Canada.
Let's go to Canada.
Mm-hmm. Mm. And I really hope we get to go to the US. North American tour, yes. I will be there. I think these guys probably will too.
Well,
so we're missing stuff.
The longest, the longest John US tour.
Yeah. Hello, it's me.
Bah.
No, it's like those posters of...
Yeah, I could do a solo version of Rufford Park. I just sit there.
When you get like one member of like an 80s band appearing at a festival, it's like... Jonathan Darley of the longest John.
On a cruise ship.
Usually the other way around. Yeah. Jonathan Darley of the longest John.
Yeah, it sounds big.
Shout out that guy from the Spinners who we were playing with in Netherlands, remember? Yeah. Just like one of them.
Okay.
Which band?
Remember? I can't. The Spinners?
Huey.
What's his name? Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That guy.
I don't look
at him. I assume he's well known in his own right. But,
he's brilliant. Yeah. He was the guy who only had one lung. And was like banging out tunes at whatever o'clock in the morning.
Trooper.
he was a true hero. What a legend. Yeah.
You know, the most. I remember going to see. There's a completely separate genre, separate gig set, right?
All
right. But I went to go and see Jurassic 5 in Bristol.
You said Jurassic Park then.
No, Jurassic 5. Like, great old school hip hop band. And like one of the guys, I can't remember which one, was outside with everyone else outside a random pub at like 3 or 4 in the morning, just watching all these other kids like just MC and beatbox and stuff. And he was just there like, I thought this dude's got to be in his 60s. He's been doing this for 30 years. He's still outside at 3 in the morning with the kids like just listening to them. I am not going to be doing that when I'm 60.
Down the pub scene.
Then again.
Fit in with everyone in the shanty scene, then.
Yeah.
Although, have you ever thought about that? That sort of as the time progresses, if more and more bands that start taking over, we're going to lose like a lot of the bands we like. And then we're going to be them.
Yeah, like going, we'll be the old ones.
Everybody, just start singing, please. I do not want to do this alone.
That's why we've got to like spread the word as far and wide now as we can, so that it'll save us awkwardness when we get old.
You don't always have to be number two. We're number three, though.
Yeah, we are. It's true.
Yeah. It's a shame.
I'm not sure there's any sites that UK is number one on now, to be fair. Anymore? I mean, we post a lot to the UK. From the website, but that's because postage costs more when you go overseas, so I think less people are inclined. But I still think we send the most to the US.
Mm. Pretty good going.
Yeah. I now know a lot about postage.
Mm. Well done.
And how much it
very
costs.
Very careful about measuring everything perfectly.
Tell you what, one package was overweight, and the guy at the post office, because we chat to him loads, and he's a good pal now. He unpacked it and repacked it so it was under the weight limit for us. And it's like, oh yeah, I just moved like a few bits and moved some stuff around, got it under the weight limit.
I suppose he has to bring it back to you though if it.
Well, he left it in the store, and then when I came in, he said, "Oh, I did this, and this is what I put it in now. Is that okay?"
I don't think you can change the weight of an item by moving stuff in.
Well, he took some like little bit. It was like fractionally over, so it's like just a bit of extra packing that needs to come out, sort of thing. And he changed the box so it was a bit better and underweight.
He's died.
Yeah, bless him. But what a legend! He's really nice. I gave him a CD a little while ago because he's just been super friendly and super nice with it all. So there you go.
Good, yeah.
Post. Be nice to your postman. Yeah. They're cool, apparently.
Postman has a lot of power when you think about it.
Yeah. Just playing with a disc.
Your mum's giving out your measurements in chat.
What?
Mum,
do you want my bank card? I've got it here.
You're getting doxxed by your mum.
What was my address? What was the hospital I was born in? Yeah,
what's your national insurance number?
Yeah, that's a useful one.
What's your maiden name, Ruth?
Oh yeah, and the name of your first pet.
I'm sorry, but we are teasing. However, please don't give away my personal information on chats. Oh, good times.
JD is a noodle.
Yes, that is actually fine. I am 6'5".
Unless maybe someone's like making you a jacket or something.
Yeah.
Make us some cloak. We'll go out. I'll measure.
JD is the tallest, maybe. And he is called John. He is the longest John.
Oh, don't apologise. I'm just teasing my mum. She possibly knows that I'm not being serious, but I hope she does.
Well,
it's fine. I'll talk to her later. That'd be. I know some of the people in. Chat and Discord and stuff are like really good at making outfits and stuff. That'd be pretty
fun. We make some ABBA style
spandex
rolls and everything.
Amazing.
Shanty themed like jumpsuit.
Oh yeah.
With ropes and tassels and things.
Anchor. Just hanging off the butt.
Ooh.
I want one of those.
Oh, is it my choice next?
White HMS pinafore.
Ooh, what do I want?
Sailing suits and a mop.
What guitar seas. Ones are not near the top?
Captain of the Queen's Navy.
Most of them.
Burn.
Hoist him around the Cape Bar, nowhere to be seen.
Oh, we haven't done Eli on one of these streams for ages.
Eli's not nowhere.
Not nowhere.
Not nowhere in his.
Eli the Barrow Boy. Haven't seen him for weeks.
Don't come round here anymore.
Your mum's crying, Jenny. You made your mother cry.
No.
Shame.
No, I was being silly. I was joking. Yeah, I could do Eli. I was joking, Mum. Don't worry. I'm sorry.
You're a bad son.
Oh,
bad
no. Son. No.
Shame.
I'm not allowed this sweet anymore. Well, that's my punishment. I unwrapped it, and now I'm not going to be allowed it. Can I have that guitar so I can strum it?
Yeah.
Tell you what, what would Mum like me to play? There you go. Mum, I'm deferring my JD's choice to you.
I mean, she's been donating just for JD's choice.
Oh,
already,
okay.
So.
I mean, actually, I know she likes Eli. I'm gonna hope that's what she'd like. It's either gonna be that or probably Fairly Well, I would guess. but just in case. Crying with laughter. Oh, that's all right.
No.
Okay. Well, in that case, I will have my sweet.
Forget everything I just said.
Yeah, I'll go with the other. Oh, my pick's not in there. It's over there next to you. You haven't licked it, have you?
Well, this one. No, I haven't.
Oh, good.
I licked all my own.
That's
fine.
That did happen the other day. Oh, Mum wants... Okay, Mum wants fairly well. I'm going to do fairly well. Oh, that's fine.
It's for guitars again.
Yeah.
It's for guitars.
Guitar bearer. My guitar.
It's fine.
I changed the key of this. I moved up a smidge. Because it sounds really nice. In E rather than D. So I hope you're ready.
I was going to ask you about that.
What, E rather than D?
Yeah, I was going to say it was really interesting.
Yeah. I mean, I'm interested.
You know how I need to be kept abreast of these things, do you?
Well, you sing the high bits, so if I move stuff up, I feel like it's my responsibility to keep you informed.
I think it'll be alright. To be honest, we haven't played this in ages, and I can't even remember. For the life of me, if it is even high or not. I think it is.
Oh, JD, you've broken anathema, Bob, by changing songs. Got facts
oh,
for
I'm sorry.
In the chat.
My mum does have super taste. To be fair, my parents have been to pretty much, well, not every gig because they've not been able to physically, but they've been to as many gigs as physically possible
they
for
are
them.
Some of our biggest supporters.
Yeah, since the very first time I ever like played in public, and they weren't even expecting to be there for that. So yeah, they very very much. Wonderful and supportive and lovely people, so do go give them the love.
They've been a fan of you for considerably longer.
What, sorry?
They've been a fan of you for considerably longer than that, since even before the band.
I thought
started.
I was rubbish.
They
were, they're like this evening. I was pretty bad before that. There we go. So sure as a bird, flying high above. Life ain't worth living without the one you love. Fare thee well, oh honey.
That's for you, boot up.
I'll send that one back over. Yeah. Yay! Oh, man. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. I really love playing that song. It makes me happy. Oh, now I've got all crisps in my eyes.
Yeah.
It's crisps!
Crying his little eyes out.
It's just crisps!
So emotional.
Oh. Yeah, you thought I was just closing my eyes because it was emotional, but no, I just had crisps.
Salt and vinegar. That sounds bad.
And it is.
Salt and retina.
Retina.
Delicious. Yay! Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I really enjoyed playing that. That made me very happy. I'm gonna have my sweet now. My good boy sweet. Means I won't be able to sing for like 5 minutes because these things are so chewy.
Yeah.
Chewy.
Mm. It's just so chewy. Good to me. Right, a few more questions.
Yes.
In case you don't know, we are reading chat, and our mods are reading chat. Come in.
Yeah.
Wonder why that's there.
Oh. Oh, that's my buzzer on the quiz.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Good point. I thought you were pretending to be that dude from Breaking Bad.
I bought that in Belgium.
Ask me a question.
What is...
I just realised it only works with yes and no questions. Did Dave kill you?
Yeah, I bought that in Blankenburg when we were there with Budok.
Oh, yeah.
And you bought... What did you buy from the same stand?
What did I buy?
It was something dumb.
It was still... It was like just markets of just...
What you bought was on the same level as, like, a rubber duck or, like, a squeezy chicken.
Oh, wait. I vaguely...
What was it? Budok, you were there. Do you remember?
It was definitely... Was it the...
Bike horn. It was a bike horn.
It was a bike horn. Oh yeah, we used it on the stream.
Good job.
That bike horn's definitely made its money back.
Yeah, it did. That was that was great.
What we used it for now.
We used it on the stream and that was it.
And your quiz, sort of.
Yeah.
Amazing.
You kept paralyzing my microphone every time I used it. My microphone.
That's hilarious. Have you guys heard of Acorn to Arabella? You should check them out. They're building a wooden ship. You should drop by and sing for them.
Where are they building a wooden ship?
Is this like a Noah situation? Did they think we're going to get flooded?
a Noah situation.
Without any more information, I would have to say I have no idea.
Ooh, we're building a 38-foot sailboat from stump to ship.
Oh, wow.
Oh, is this you? I think I have seen something. I've seen similar stuff, people building like
is it in
giant
the UK?
Boats in the backyard. What is it about? When it comes to Arabella. The project.
They're in the US somewhere. Well, says Vincent Henning.
It's going to be difficult.
Yeah, that's going to be harder. Yeah, I have actually seen this.
Looks pretty cool.
On YouTube, yeah. It looks great. Cool. It's like an old... They're putting together a boat like how it would have been done.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Well, I think they made a few improvements, but... I saw that one episode sort of vaguely in the background, so I'm not going to say anything else, but...
Yeah,
It looked pretty cool.
Nice one. Yeah, I'll check it out, definitely. Mm-hmm. Well, if you follow them on the page and say hi or anything, that'd be pretty fun. Happily do some songs or something for them, or chat to them. Yar! We'll have a listen to what that is in a second. Next question. How do you work out what harmonies to sing? Like this. Done.
Or we do that over and over again until it sounds good.
Yep.
No, but we do that, and then we decide what kind of song we're singing after that chord.
Yes.
So now we're singing
The song that came to my head after hearing that was Made of Amsterdam for some reason. I don't know why.
It was a pretty spicy chord, I'll give you
that. It was definitely pretty spicy. It had maximum spice.
How do we actually sing?
I mean...
kind of like that.
I mean, one person...
with a song and trying to
very
sound
very organically.
Yeah. One person learns the melody, usually. Unless it's like a split song where we share the melody. And then you have a vague idea of, well, if you're doing that bit, I'll do the low bit, you'll do the high bit.
We get down, we go side to side.
And then we just kind of fiddle around with that until we go, yeah, I'm happy with my part, it sounds cool. Yeah. And we're like, yeah, the whole thing sounds pretty good together.
No, let's put a weird chord at this point.
Yeah, we get sassy.
Yeah, we never really, we don't really learn off sheet music or anything.
No, so. Things get sassier as the longer we've learned them, usually. Either in terms of we do more silly things when we're on stage, or we put in more interesting parts and chords.
Yeah.
Generally. Are there any more donations to read?
Hence why the entire of Bones in the Ocean doesn't sound anything like the original anymore, because we've had 5 years to just hire
and
stuff on top of it.
And member
three different members.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, indeed.
I miss Josh.
Rip.
I hate Robbie.
And Anna too, but it's less insulting to Robbie if I say I miss Anna.
As long as you're getting the giggles, I don't care.
Anna came around and hung out in the garden the other day and played some banjo. We had some really nice. She waved at Joey. It's really cool.
Doesn't kind of hang out in my garden.
Doesn't play banjo in my garden.
You should.
Yeah, any more donation
reads?
Yes!
Mile Bit says, tossing in a fiver for Anne Louise.
Yay!
Jedi says, here's a help to the company from Lithuania.
Nice.
And Metwatch says, my shoes are legendary. My shoes are over there. You can't see my shoes. What? These are my socks.
Is Metwatch saying his shoes are legendary?
No, Dave's shoes are legendary.
Oh, Dave's shoes.
Just wanted to let you guys know that my shoes are legendary.
Yep.
Just
I've got
you know.
Some legendary shoes in Assassin's Creed.
And Sam Morris says, I hope you're all being safe and adequate. Chicken on a raft, please. This is
Thanks, Sam.
This is a song for my nephew who heard you sing a few months ago. Now he's a fan of yours, only 7-year-old I know, that sings shanties.
Yeah.
It does take a few months to get used to it, doesn't it?
I got sent a really beautiful video today by a very good friend of mine, Abby's, who I don't know if you've met. Have you met Paul? You've met Paul.
Which Paul?
Handsome Paul.
Handsome Paul? Not Paul O'Connor.
No, other Handsome Paul.
No, another Handsome Paul.
To be fair, of like handsome men,
Paul,
those guys are definitely... like
Paul, just a handsome name for him, and he just does something for you.
Well...
Who is he?
Old friend of Abby. Used to work with Abby.
Oh, no, yeah, I know the guy you mean.
Yeah,
the really, really attractive one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Your name is Paul and your mom is really good looking. Please write in as long as John's people.
You sent me a video of his kid. Well, they ordered a bunch of merch and stuff which arrived today, and so he sent me a nice picture and said it's all really cool and that sort of thing. And he sent me a picture of his kid dancing around the room to LBP. And he said, say R, and he's like, yar, yar, yar. As he's dancing around to the song. It's really cute. Yeah, there we go.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, pretty adorable. Boom, 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 boom. I hope he's watching. What a guy.
Yeah, we're doing kids size clothing on the next run.
Yeah, I think we should.
The little ones.
I do want Joey to wear our stuff, but...
Yeah, we might do a few limited runs where we get people to pre-order and then...
Yeah, that could work.
To make too much.
Baby things. Mm. It is a super adorable video, I have to say. One more question.
I just want to know what Paul looks like now. He's bigged him up so much.
I can find you.
Is he that good? Is he that handsome?
Sweet.
Is that a feast for the eyes?
I mean, him and Paul O'Connor, I kind of think are like, in terms of attractive men.
Yeah.
I've got my own tier list of attractive men. But I don't think we need to talk about that, that's true.
No? Fair enough.
Where's
a good one?
Next one.
Where's he looking, Swish?
Just come in with our lists.
I've got a spreadsheet and stuff.
I mean, all of these.
Metwatch says, I meant socks, but my Budapesters with steel toes are legendary as well. But what I usually don't brag about them.
He's a little bit younger there.
Yeah. I mean...
sure, we've all got issues.
Anyway, that's enough about Handsome Paul.
I mean, that was quite a build-up. Yeah, cool, yeah. It's a bloke.
Fair enough. Right.
I think I possibly know this person as Top Hat Paul.
Really?
Is that a different Paul?
Handsome and posh. Wow.
I don't remember him ever wearing a top hat.
Okay.
Maybe that's
someone
else.
Caps and stuff. Yeah, maybe. Who knows? Oh no, that's another of Abby's old friends.
That was a pool, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was also a Paul.
Not Top Hat Paul.
Top Hat Paul.
He's Techie Paul.
Okay.
That'll do. Techie Paul.
Top Hat Paul.
Top
Hat
Paul.
You know too many Pauls. Get rid of them.
Categorise them all.
Oh dear, what a bizarre tangent. Song?
The tangent went too far.
Yeah.
It's a railroad at the top.
Give me a note. I'll sing you a song.
We're starting to learn that. We're starting to learn your intro for this.
Oh yeah, that was really good.
Oh yeah, we really do that.
When we start touring, we need to get that in there. Because that'll be a...
I do remember it.
I remember it. It gets stuck in my head all the time.
You've got
it's
it recorded,
brilliant.
Haven't you?
Oh, good. We'll do it at some point.
Give me
a space.
Oh.
And I'll give you a
home.
Don't try not sass me, Dave.
Way on a railroad,
coat on my brow, boots stealing my soul.
Way on the railroad, picking up coal and we're picking up speed. Shovel as much as the engine needs. Sweat and blood gonna earn my pay. All the way to Frisco Bay.
Hey. Going through hills trying to make up time.
Way on the railroad.
Ain't nothing gonna stand in the way of our line.
Way on the railroad. Picking up coal and we're picking up speed. Shovel as much as the engine needs. Ain't no slave, but we slave away. All the way to Frisco Bay.
Ha! Surveyors trying to plan which route is best. Ha!
Way on the railroad.
Just draw a straight line from east to west.
Ha! Way on the railroad. Picking up coal and we're picking up speed. Shovel as much as the engine needs. Ain't no slave, but we slave away. All the way to Frisco Bay.
Hey. Boss man says that a malady's the peace.
Way on the railroad.
I'll make two for the look on his face.
Way on the railroad. Picking up coal and we're picking up speed. Shovel as much as the engine needs. Ain't no slave, but we slave away. All the way to Frisco Bay.
Span no quarter and we'll span no man.
Way on the railroad.
Pray we don't run into the Cheyenne.
Way on the railroad. Picking up coal and we're picking up speed. Shovel as much as the engine needs. Sweat and blood gonna earn my pay. All the way to Frisco Bay, picking up coal and picking up speed. Shovel as much as the engine needs. Ain't no slave, but we slave away. All the way to Frisco Bay, picking up coal and picking up speed. Shovel as much as the engine needs. If I should fall, leave me where I lay. On the railway to Frisco Bay.
Choo choo.
It's F, isn't it?
F sharp. Sure. Might have dropped a semitone.
There's like a lower note, and I used to go to it every now and then, but I felt too low for me. Might just be me. I'm just being silly. That was lovely. Man, what a great song. Banger. Banging that.
Hype train to Frisco Bay.
On the hype train to Frisco Bay, I would ride that train. Carrotties! Hi!
Hi, Carrotties!
Hi!
Hi!
For those who don't know, Carities is another one of our very good friends from Twitch, who is a fabulous streamer who we stream with quite a lot.
I like you, Carities. You're good.
Brilliant. You make us good at the games. but yeah, again, another really cool person to go and follow. If you like your Sea of Thieves with great entertainment and great character and fun, go and follow Carities. She's great. And yeah, streams with us a bunch too. It's really good fun.
Find those streams on our other YouTube channel. Oh, hey,
you live us guys too.
Live.
I'm gonna. You like. I wasn't sure which way that was going. Not love, just like.
Yeah.
We're okay. All right. We have our times.
You are.
Carities helped me get Granny Inferno, like public character, to Pirate Legend the other day.
Yeah,
it's really cool.
JD hit Pirate Legend with his
character. Yeah, I now have two characters that are Pirate Legends.
And then you did the purple palm tree wave.
We all stood in a circle around some cats and waved, and it was all
got in our Pirate Legend garb. It's great. Very, very good fun. That was a top stream.
Mm.
We planned to go for like a few hours and we ended up going till 10.
Yeah. Things happened.
Things happened. Good things.
Time
very
was
good
not
things.
Looked at. Carity streams on Twitch. She's cool.
Cool.
Buddha's already put a link in chat. Yay. I was about to say, mods.
Yeah.
Do a thing.
Do your work.
No, they already done it. That's good job.
More questions. Let's see some more questions from the floor.
Question time.
Oh. There's only 25 minutes left.
There is.
Of official time.
Dun, dun, dun.
Goodness me. Man, that's flown by today. Goodness me. That's crazy.
Are you having fun or something?
I'm having great fun. Man, I have missed this. Like, 4 weeks after doing it so often has felt like such a long time. Yeah.
Yes.
Right. When you, I'm going to just whittle through these questions as quick as I can. There's quite a few.
Hit me.
When you guys play D&D, who gets to play the bard?
Sam. No one. No bard.
Sam always plays the bard.
The only bard we've had was Sam.
Sam's always the bard.
I
don't want to be the bard when I'm playing in my fantasy land.
I would be tempted.
I'm already the bard in real life.
I'd be tempted next time. Do you guys have any idea on what kind of game the Longest John's board game will be?
A good one.
Good one. We're talking ideas. Nothing's set yet, but we'll see. Question. Longest John's minifigs? Maybe.
We'll definitely get some for ourselves. You might not be able to buy them. But
we'll see. Yeah, we'll see. I mean, the printer can make some pretty badass ones, but we'd want to have something that's like good and repeatable. And
I want a bust of my head and shoulders, like as big as you can make in the thing.
They'd be pretty fun. You can get 3D scanners for your phone and stuff.
Sure, we'll
get a scan of your face.
Yeah. You just want a little statue.
Yeah, we'll get
yourself.
Like four of them.
Everyone make a silly face. Just
it'd be great.
Getting it on Sam as well.
Have we ever been in Switzerland? Not as a band.
I have.
I
went to Interlaken.
Was it good?
It was great.
Great.
I think I landed in the airport and then drove into France. That's about as far as I went. What are you guys' opinion on the Irish Rovers? They're a band.
They're good.
Which ones are the Irish Rovers?
There's a lot that have Irish in the name.
Yeah.
They're like the Dubliners, but
not
more
the
recent.
Dubliners. Okay.
I feel like...
Are they rowdier than the Dubliners?
I don't know.
I think the answer is we don't know well enough. But everything I remember, I think they're pretty cool.
I'm pretty sure they just play a lot of, like, trad Irish stuff, which is pretty great in my books. So,
Are sheets, music, and chords and so going to be released? If so, when? It's currently being worked on. We are planning on songbooks and stuff. They've been worked on by the wonderful Lump, who's also the fabulous... Actually, she's Lucy Humphreys in chat.
Yeah.
At the moment. She also is the person who played the trumpet for us on Moby Duck. And
that's
is a phenomenal musician and player and wonderful friend and mod as well. So she's actually working on that for us, which is pretty mega. So no set times or anything yet, but it is in progress and it will exist. One thing I don't know about, which I would consider for some of the songs, is I'd be quite tempted to try and tab out some of the guitar ones as well and get the chords and stuff in there as well.
Be useful for people.
Because... the most useful music I've ever seen in books is ones that have the sheet music with like the melody and all the other bits and stuff going on, and it's got the chords and it's got the tab. And that might be a bit extreme, but it's definitely like the most useful. But it might just be like one line of the song is a page at that point with all of that information of all of our parts and everything on there.
Yeah.
So we'll see. But either way, who is your favourite band, Shanty or not? Ooh.
Tough.
Gut answers. No time to think. Go, Robbie.
Dreadnought.
Radiohead. No time to think. First band.
Clutch.
No, don't think.
First aid kit.
There we go.
Nice.
Good choice. They're cool. They're very cool. Good choices, everyone. Good choices. I like it. Hey, lads, what instruments do you each play? Curious musician here.
I play faders.
This one. Buttons.
Faders and buttons.
I play strings.
I play computer.
I play this one and I play this one and I play this one.
You cut some holes in the cube, but play that one.
To some degree, quite a few things, but guitar is definitely mine.
Dave plays tubes with holes in.
Yeah.
My baby. Mm. You play banjo.
I play these two.
And guitar, but you kind of don't anymore.
I don't.
By choice.
Really, I learned guitar and now I just...
You're a very good guitarist.
It's all right. I don't really enjoy it much. Although some...
You're doing it wrong.
You're right, Andy. People who play guitar are losers.
Hang on. I think I just don't really enjoy playing acoustic guitar very much. What I do enjoy is playing electric guitar.
That's because you're wrong. You're doing it wrong. Do it better. Yeah.
there's nothing quite the same as an electric guitar in a decent sized amp on full distortion.
Yeah, it's
pretty
great.
There's nothing. It's just.
I want it big and fuzzy. That's what I want.
Faces slug thing, where someone replaced the famous guitarist pulling that guitar face and just put giant slugs in their hands.
Yeah.
It's fantastic. If you haven't seen it before, just look for guitar face slug, and you will be amused for at least. Minutes. Great, okay, so we're running towards the end of the stream, so we're planning on finishing in like 20 minutes. We may overrun a little bit because we were a little bit late starting, but
we'll say this is the estuary of the event.
Can we?
Estuary?
Towards the end of the
end of the stream.
Okay. Before we put out to sea.
Yeah, there we go.
Instant rim
that's
shot.
Kind of,
that wasn't that bad.
That was pretty good. That was pretty bad.
That's clever enough.
It was pretty bad.
That's clever enough. I kind of like
Come on, there's a whole sea bit in there as well. I wrapped the whole thing up nice with the
foam. Amazing. So yeah, if there are any songs you're absolutely desperate to hear...
Good enough for you, is it, Dave?
I liked it. if there's any songs you're desperate to hear and they're not currently in the top, we are still taking donations for all the songs in the song list. You can donate through using the link in below, the Stream Elements link, which does get us a slightly better rate from the tips and everything as well. Or you can super chat for the song. Do write us a lovely message as well, and Dave will read them out as they come in too. And yeah, otherwise we're going to try and rattle through some things. I'd normally give some like announcements of like what gigs and stuff we got coming up, but like really, I would say watch out on Wednesdays for new videos coming out from us.
Yeah.
With the Black Flag stuff, by the way, because I know quite a few people have been watching that, and someone even asked a thing about that, I think, earlier, which I possibly missed. I don't know. They are still being made. We have actually finished the game now for recording
It's
purposes.
All recorded. They just take a long time to edit.
Yeah, so we stopped doing them on Thursdays now. We slowed it down just a little bit with them, and we're going to kind of release them on part of the Wednesday schedule as well every now and then to wait through the game. But yeah, it's getting very close. We've got a few more songs to do. Very fun.
I would expect about one a month, maybe.
Yeah, probably on that sort of schedule, but we'll see. We'll see how they're coming. So yeah, watch out for new videos every Wednesday. We've got some really good ones coming up soon. Next stream is in 4 weeks' time, which get in your diaries now.
Oh, yeah.
I'm saying this to us as well as you. 1, 2, 3, 4, which is the 19th of August. No. In fact, it's already in my calendar. Look at that.
Yeah. I'm there.
Banging.
I'm busy.
No, you're not.
Get unbusy.
I'm doing it.
That sounds like a sooty and sweet thing. Izzy,
no, it's
Wizzy,
my,
get
it's
unbusy.
It's my 90s dance hit. Get unbusy.
Unbusy also sounds
like... Get your hands on your hips, take a step to the right, get unbusy. Get unbusy.
It also sounds like a sort of pop R&B artist as well.
Sure.
MC Unbusy.
No.
No?
I don't think you're quite...
I saw what you were going with.
Yeah.
I
shouldn't have said MC. That's the wrong thing.
You sound like a dad.
I am a dad. I've got the baby. He's like this big. And he goes...
And he's finally had a child and grown into himself. That's the weird part.
Now all the cringy dad stuff that he used to do makes sense.
Yeah. That was justified.
Now suddenly, oh, thank goodness.
Fantastic. Right. Right.
Left.
Damn it. So that's... that's all.
We are really
I'm just going to eat my sweets for the rest of the time. Screw the songs. We'll rattle through as much as we can. Thank you ever so much for being here. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, go like like one of our other videos or like this one and comment on them and say hi and share it to your friends. Even if you don't think anyone will watch it, share it anyway because it all helps us out. It's all really nice. Yeah.
Song.
What is it?
Song.
Anne Louise. Song. Anne Louise. Oh, the Anne
Louise. Cool. Cool to
sing a song.
Please.
Oh, the Anne.
I don't remember, that's a third. Oh, the Anne Louise is waiting for a crew to jump aboard to take us out to deeper waters further from the shore. For it's quiet and still in the harbour, not a voice to be heard in the bay, but the wind's coming down from Norway and there's plenty to be done today.
Ho, cast off, me lads, we'll set the sails on anchor, she's been cast before some action out on the open seas. Oh, there's nothing quite like pitching along at dangerous speeds with my hand on the tiller of my sky blue westerly.
Oh, we've coffee and we've bacon and we've everything on board.
Ooh,
so cry the crew, cast off from this safe haven, we've been moored. For there's
salt wind in our lungs, boys,
and salt blood in our veins. But the wind's coming down from Norway, making horses beyond the cranes.
Ho, cast off, me lads, we'll set the sails hard in, cause she's been gasping for some action out on the open seas. Oh, there's nothing quite like pitching along at dangerous speeds with my hand on the tiller of my sky blue westerly.
Oh, she may be kind of small, but she's got everything and more for a crew of hopeless sea dogs to lose out of the shore. We may be back in a month.
Hooray!
We may be back in a day, but the wind's coming down from Norway and there's no way that we can say,
oh, cast off, my lads, we'll set the sails hard in, cause she's been gasping for some action out on the open seas. Oh, there's nothing quite like pitching along at dangerous speeds with my hand on the tiller of my sky blue westerly.
Oh, the Anne Louise has had her fill and now we must away to walk upon the shores and share the stories of the day. We may sleep well in our beds tonight, we may not be back here for days, but the wind's coming down from Norway and our dreams will be on the waves.
Ho, cast off, me lads, we'll set the sails hard in, cause she's been gasping for some action out on the open seas. Oh, there's nothing quite like pitching along at dangerous speeds with my hand on the tiller of my sky blue westerly. Oh, cast off, me lads, we'll set the sails hard in, cause she's been gasping for some action out on the open seas. Oh, there's nothing quite like pitching along at dangerous speeds with my hand on the tiller.
With my hand on the tiller.
With my hand on the tiller of my sky blue westerly.
Oh, it's a high. It's a high song.
Come on, stop me, lads.
Dying.
Yeah. I don't know what happened to me there. I think I just got like a... You know when you have sweets?
Or
like,
you know when you eat things?
Oh, and then you sugar for you.
It makes you all salivate and stuff. Some just decided that was the time to make a leap for the throat.
Yeah.
There we go. Just a bit of sweet getting excited. Right, what's next?
Sweet.
4 hours.
4 hours.
Four hours.
I love frowers.
Four hours.
4 hours.
I think I saw someone asking when we're going to release our next album.
Yeah.
I feel like
tomorrow.
I feel like we,
people are insatiable.
We just released one. We just released one. Let us rest.
4 years of work.
2 years.
Man, we haven't even played like Hoist Up the Thing around the Cape.
We've not even gigged our album.
We've not even gigged.
No,
we've done a single gig
since releasing the album.
Yeah,
the album tracks.
We're gonna start doing these live. And find we can't do it, we have to go back and.
Oh no, we're really bad.
We stuck.
I'm banned from sweets, yeah.
In 4 hours.
Yeah.
Yep.
See you.
I ate a crisp.
Regret.
It was a bad choice.
Instant regret.
Honk.
Alright, I'm ready. You ready, kids?
Come, my boys, and heave with me. Let's get off this cursed sea.
What?
Let's be home to lovers and wives and leave behind these 4 hour lives.
Four hours.
Working on the swell.
Four hours.
Slogging in the rain.
Four hours.
Working to the bell. Then
four hours till it starts again.
Come, my boys, and heave with me. The wind's my friend and my enemy. It carries me home, but it must be tamed.
Everything lost or everything gained.
Four hours working on the swell.
Four hours
slogging in the rain.
Four hours
working to the bell. Then
four hours till it starts again.
Come here, boys, and heave with me. Got scabrous hands and bloody knees. But when the bell tolls, I'll go below. My hands will callous and my strength will grow.
4 hours
working on the swell.
4 hours
slogging in the rain.
4 hours
working to the bell. Then
4 hours till it starts again.
Come here, boys, and heave away. Soaked and heavy, heaving under the spray. Will I ever shed this salt on my brow? Batter the dust from under my plough.
4 hours
working on the swell.
4 hours
slogging in the rain.
4 hours
working to the bell. Then
4 hours till it starts again.
When I'm back in Bristol town, I'll buy my love a silken gown. We'll lie in each other's arms and rest until that bell sounds in my chest.
4 hours
working on the swell.
4 hours
slogging in the rain.
4 hours
working to the bell. Then
4 hours till it starts again. 4 hours hauling on the sheets. 4 hours keeping our feet. 4 hours wrap me in the shroud. And 4 hours lay me in the ground.
I love that song so much.
Those last choruses were...
Oh, they're so good. That's still my favourite song off the album.
Really?
Yeah. That's my favourite.
Wow, Anathema Bot's got so much info about 4 hours.
Yeah, I know. It's packed full of information.
Oh, wow. Void Null has given us 100 rubs.
Thanks.
That's £1 a letter, JD.
100 rubs.
Is it?
I assume it's rubles.
It's so exciting to read.
Just big numbers are exciting. Sure. Big numbers are exciting.
Fun fact, Russian sailors did not have shanties for work because back in the day the law demanded silence on deck. To hear the captain's commands. Sure.
There we go.
So Russian shanties.
Russia does not sound fun.
No.
That's
right. Nope. Harrison wants bones in the ocean. Didn't Heart about woodworking back for Andy Weeze. I had to go to meetings, so I missed most of the stream, but I'm back now. Vincent Hennig says, bones in the ocean. It was my first of my songs I ever heard. It's still one of my favourites. And Metawash loves his shoes.
Yeah, loves his shoes.
Yeah.
Great.
He's put a pestis with steel toes.
I'm down. Great. Oh, that's super cool. I definitely got more excited for the rubs than I should have, but it's still really generous.
Don't
thank
say you.
You
want 100 rubs.
What? It's still funny. Goodness me. Right. More songs. I got no more questions and stuff, just because we're piling through songs at the moment. Anything else?
Nope.
Exciting to say? Nope.
Nope.
Next song?
Yeah, not much.
Again, if there's anything you're desperate for, we are still taking donations for all the things. So,
yes.
We've got like 10 minutes.
It's worth mentioning
left.
Again, if you haven't received your merch yet, it's because we're just waiting on the vinyl.
Oh, yeah.
Just remember. So please wait.
Responsibly.
How long? Yeah, wait a responsible amount of time before mailing us about it.
Yeah, so if your order from the pre-order, or even from the website as well, doesn't contain a vinyl, it has been posted. It has been posted. Some of it has definitely been this week, so still give it, like, especially if you're overseas, up to 2 weeks. Or 1 week if you're in the UK. And if it hasn't arrived then do let us know and we'll chase it up and see what's going on. But it has all been posted, other than the stuff with the vinyls, because they will be arriving with us, hopefully in the next 2 weeks.
Maybe three.
And maybe three. And then we'll be sending them out with all the other orders as soon as they do. So yeah, thank you so much for being so patient. Mm-hmm. Like, we were hoping to have them when the album came out on launch day, but delays happened and then... they messed up and then delays happened again, so happy days, but they'll get there and they're still going to be really, really cool, and I can't wait to get my hands on them. There we go. I'm sure you're the same.
So
thank you for bearing with us, and please just hold on just a little bit longer and it'll be with you.
I realised we didn't talk about the Moby Duck project earlier.
Oh, we didn't, no.
No, Dave, tell us about the Moby Duck
project. We're doing a Moby Duck community video project where I have divided the lyrics of the song into individual lines and give them out to people to make some kind of image, whether it's drawn by hand and then photographed or drawn on the computer. We've had someone do like needlecraft. Someone was using a 3D printer to make pigs. But yeah, I've given out all of the lyrics. If you're desperate to get involved and can do it fairly quickly, then message me and we'll try and get some duplicates in there. We might, you know, loop the last chorus a few extra times to get some more pictures or something like that. But if I have given you a line already, if you could get it to me in the next month or so, that would be useful. I've currently got like less than a third. So you send me more, I'll start putting it together, and then it's fine. It would be way quicker than at this point. It'll probably come out before Leave
Possibly
Johnny,
will, yeah. We
email people.
Yeah, we got to do the emails, and it's still compiling, and then even just rendering it's going to take a few days, I reckon.
Yeah.
I'd just not be able to use the PC for a couple of days whilst it's pumping out the video.
Oh yeah, message me at dave@thelongestjohns.com.
Yes.
This is the email.
Dave@thelongestjohns.com.
There is also a channel, chat channel in the Discord as well.
Oh yeah, Discord's a good place to be if you want to keep updated with what we do.
Or if you just want to hang out and chat with us and like-minded people. It's a cool place. It's a very cool place. Anything else we haven't said about? Oh, Twitch. Follow us on Twitch.
Discord.
We stream there a bunch.
Yes.
It's going to take a while to see all the different things, but we stream most days at the moment.
Twitch
play
is
lots
fun.
Of games and
yeah,
sing
yeah.
songs and
if you
want to
hang out with us in a more informal environment and
yes.
just watch us play video games,
yes.
come to Twitch.
Happy days. Right. Song. What is it?
Bonds.
Bonds?
In?
Bonds and the Ocean.
Ooh. What's an Ocean?
What's it like
D. D for Dave.
I bid farewell to the port and the land, and I paddled away from brave England's white sands to search for my long ago forgotten friends, to search for the place I hear all sailors end.
As the souls of the dead fill the space on my mind, I'll search without sleeping till peace I can find. I fear not the weather, I fear not the sea. I remember the fallen, do they think of me? When their bones in the ocean forever will be.
Plot a course to the night, to a place I once knew, to a place where my hope died along with my crew. So I swallow my grief and face life's final test to find promise of peace and the solace of rest.
As the souls of the dead fill the space of my ears, their laughter like children, their beckoning cheers, my heart longs to join them, sing songs of the sea. I remember the fallen, do they think of me? When their bones in the ocean forever will be.
When at last before my ghostly shipmates I stand, I shed a small tear for my home upon land. Yeah, that's a lie. Though their eyes speak of deaths filled with struggle and strife, their smiles below say I don't owe them my life.
As the souls of the dead fill the space of my eyes, and my boat listed over and tried to capsize, I'm this far from drowning, this far from the sea. I remember the living, do they think of me? When my bones in the ocean forever will be.
Now that I'm staring down at the darkest abyss, I'm not sure what I want, but I don't think it's this. As my comrades call to stand fast and forge on, I make sail for the dawn till the darkness has gone.
As the souls of the dead live forever in my mind, as I live all the years that they left me behind, I'll stay on the shore but still gaze at the sea. I remember the fallen and they think of me, for our souls in the ocean together will be.
I remember the fallen and they think of me, for our souls in the ocean together will be.
Not the bees!
Bees.
Not the bees!
I hear you can't stop them.
Can't stop the bees.
Can't stop.
Can't stop the bees.
Go! Can't stop.
Ruining the end of serious song.
Yeah, it's my song. I'll ruin it if I want to.
Oh, that was aggressive.
I saw a Katie Sky pop up in chat a second ago.
Who's that? How you doing?
Yeah.
Sure, it wasn't Kale Chips. That name looks a bit like Katie Sky.
Does it?
Kale Chips.
Does it?
Bees.
Oh, lots of hearts.
Hi, Katie Sky.
What's she saying?
Love this song, boys. Smiley face, heart.
Oh, you love the Longest John's favourite band, literally. Thank you so much, Ash Mac Cool. That's really kind. Yeah.
We're doing stuff that people like.
That's a good feeling. That's a lovely feeling. Oh, Kate Sky is there. Look, she made a face.
She said, I'm here.
Yeah.
Get back in the kitchen.
Robbie, no.
Oh, damn. Nah. Quick, throw objects at him. Like sweets.
Away with your machete.
She's probably in the bath. I broke our shower quite recently, so we have to have baths now. Because I went, I can fix it, and I couldn't. And now it's wrecked.
That's the most used story I've ever
heard.
Yeah.
No, I'll go up halfway. So now I've got to get a real dude into it. Good
job.
Oh dear. Right. It's almost 5:30. I reckon two more.
Two more.
I think two more is good. So yeah, if there's anything desperate for, there's still time.
Romina's still tipped crossing the bar over the edge. Thanks for the wonderful stream.
Goodbye, crossing the bar.
And DRK Michael says, curious what else you'll love it. Always have it on with my friends while playing Sea of Thieves. Such a mood bringer.
Yeah.
Oak and Ash of Thorns and Moby Duck are my favourites.
Yeah.
And I'll put it towards Oak and Ash then.
Yeah.
Samora says, Robbie Salonica to that shower.
Before Salonica on the shower.
Yeah. Well, no. The shower is Salonica itself, and then I carried on doing the verses. Further Salonica it more.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah. I love that. I love that that's the thing.
Salonica as a word is gaining more meaning. I like it.
If I get home and find that Kahlua is gone, I'm going to be unhappy.
Oh. Is it Kahlua night?
Sitting drinking White Russians.
That cherry stuff you gave us was amazing, by the way.
Can you make more?
Abby really enjoyed it.
Yeah, I'll make more as soon as I'm...
Hey, are you starting to pilfer our trees?
They're the wrong kind of cherry.
Are they? Oh, okay.
They need to be like sour cherries.
Oh, no.
Are they not sour cherries? They're sweet cherries.
Nah, sweet cherries.
Sweet
can make a different thing.
Yeah, do it in here in that thing, actually.
It's a different thing. <know. laughs> Oh, dear. Great. What song is next, then? What's currently... Number
which is
two.
Now Oaken, Ash and Thorn.
Is it?
Well, that was fast.
Is it? All right. That's a good shout. Oh, someone asked a question about that, actually. Which I did actually want to ask. Answer.
What was it?
Someone was asking about how we... Well, yeah, how and why it looked the way that it did. Partially because loads of people are really confused by the floor.
What are you talking about?
Oaken, Ash. Like, people think that it must have been a green screen because the floor was clean, or like clear, in the forest.
It's the summer. It's not autumn.
Yeah, it's...
But did you make it look like autumn with the colours?
No, not at all. No.
It was quite a clear forest floor.
Nothing at all was done to the floor of the forest. Like, we didn't rake the floors of the forest.
It was just a heavily walked area of forest
that we decided to... That's a reference
to
that. Bonus points if you get it.
What?
Rake to the floor. I hear it's really popular in... Denmark? Finland? I can't remember.
Raking the floor.
Raking the floors of the forest, yeah. I'm making a political topical joke that's funny.
Sounds like something you should move on
from. It's funny. It's funny. Never mind. But yeah, that was just genuinely what it was like in there. And then the leaves of the trees was very much some play with the colours and stuff to make it feel like a sort of weird, magical, fun forest. I blew them up a little bit.
I blew them up.
Well done. I demand that the forest be more foresty. Yeah, we actually have to bring some leaves and branches and extra bits from home to make the forest look more foresty.
Leaves to donate to the forest.
Yeah.
Oh, Guillaume.
Yay.
Loving to see some banjo.
Banjo.
Yeah, hi Guillaume. Look, I learned the banjo. Are you proud? I pretty much wasn't playing it the last time I saw you, to be fair.
No, just me banjo.
I only learned it in like the last 11 months.
Banjo harder.
But I do not really play like flat picked Irish stuff. Nope.
done the Irish Rover video then.
Right. Ready?
Yeah.
That was adorable.
A little forest blur.
Yeah. There's a good version of that. I'll work it out at some point.
Oh no, iPad died again. Oh no.
Goodbye, iPad.
I'm going to have a second phone. Right, last song. Yeah, it's currently crossing the bar. Yeah, that feels like a really nice ending song, to be fair. So someone quick blow the note. great, thank you ever so much to everybody for watching it's great to be back again. It has felt it has felt like a long 4 weeks, I'll admit. But yeah, the next one is, as we said, on the
something of August.
19th of August. So get in your diaries. We'd love to see you again. We'll be singing more songs, having more fun. I look forward to being able to have more friends and guests on these again
singing
one day.
Singing more songs and having more friends.
I would like more friends.
And guests.
No friends,
we don't get to
no
see
friends,
half of our friends this year at festivals and whatnot.
Nope.
Madness. Madness. So many
singing
people.
Singing songs, having fun, long as John's live stream.
Yeah.
Still have a theme tune, do we?
No.
Get an intro. Imagine a proper like themed intro. That'd be so good to the stream.
It would just be us going. Rah,
in like
rah,
a
rah,
it would need to be in like a 90s like kids TV show, teens TV show style. Can we get a wall with doors on it? And we go hi.
Hi everybody.
And we pop back into the wall.
Oh gosh.
That sounds great.
Funny.
But anyway, yeah, come tune back in. We've got more videos coming out every week, every Wednesday, so watch out for those. As I say, like them, comment on them, share them. It all makes a massive difference to us growing the channel and sharing the what we do with the world, really. Whether it's people that you know or not, all of those things play into YouTube and it gets out there to more people because it makes them think, oh, we should show this to more people if more people are sharing it and watching it and that sort of thing. Yeah. Be cool, sing songs, enjoy yourselves, make the most of the lockdown if you can. But yeah, stay chill, enjoy yourself.
Stay chill, be
absolutely
cool.
Be cool.
Sing songs.
JD says,
use August John's
merch, cool.
Stay chill.
Stay chill, be cool.
No.
Get tea, have piss.
Yeah. Get tea.
That would actually be a really good shirt.
That would be a really good like, shirt. Oh, God.
The end.
It's the one on the end.
That one?
Not yet.
No. Where's
the
other
one? It's the third one. It's the third one on the top you can press.
Get
and then after you've pressed that, give it like a minute and then press the one on the bottom right.
Okay.
There you go. Robbie's in charge of the,
I'm in charge
the buttons
of stuff
tonight.
Yeah. Today.
Isn't he a special one?
Robbie controls the stream.
It's a miracle we're still alive.
I don't know how we're still alive.
Still alive.
This was a triumph. So yeah, enjoy some Crossing the Bar. What a great song to finish on. Yeah. And yeah, if you've been worried about your donation not happening or anything, it has been totaled up. All the things are visible on the donation song page, I think.
Yeah.
That's the totals there, doesn't it? And all the multipliers, that sort of stuff. And the top ones will carry over to the next stream. Great. Let's do it. Let's peace out.
I'm peacing.
Let's blow this thing and go home. Man, Star Wars
onto the microphone. I was going to do it onto the microphone, but then it's like,
that's probably for the best.
I'm ready.
Good.
Sunset an evening star, and one clear call for me, and may there be no moaning of the bar when I put out to sea. When I put out to sea. When I put out to sea, and may there be no moaning off the bar. When I put out to sea, but such a tide as moving seems asleep, too full for sound and foam. That which drew from out the boundless deep turns again home. Turns again home. Turns again home. That which drew from out the boundless deep turns again home. Twilight, an evening bell, and after that the dark, and may there be no sadness of farewell when I embark. When I embark, when I embark, and may there be no sadness or farewell, when
are born of time and place. The flood may bear me far. I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar. When I have crossed the bar. When I have crossed the bar. I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar. When I have crossed the bar. When I have crossed the bar. I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar.
You know that moment when you start humming and then you change to ooh and you just go moo?
Did you do a good? Did you do a good moo?
Oh, I feel chills after that one, and it's not just the cooler. Great. Just before we go, one last special mention to all the wonderful moderators who have been out there in chat, who have been hanging out, getting involved, chatting to folks, helping with questions and stuff that people have had that we haven't been able to answer, sending me questions, and just generally keeping everything a wonderful place. They are an incredible team that we have. I'm super proud of the people that we have working with us. They are just the best people. So please give them lots of love as well, just before we go. And I'm so used to like raiding stuff on Twitch now. I
don't know. Yeah, not on that raid on YouTube. Doesn't work.
What video should people go and watch today, Robbie, after this?
You do not want to know.
Last time you said cat.
Cat on a Roomba.
Cat on a Roomba.
Yeah.
Well, cat on a Roomba, yeah.
What can equal that?
Honestly. All I've been watching on YouTube recently is basically go, really? Oh!
makes you fall off your chair.
UFO footage.
There you go.
UFO conspiracy theories.
Somebody really needs to, like, in the last kind of few weeks or so, there's been so much more like UFO footage leaked out from things,
yeah.
And there's a whole new game afoot. What is it real? Is it not? It's probably not.
Great. Pudos has just made another great
screaming
suggestion.
Goats. Yeah. Screaming goats. All those old screaming goat videos of like Taylor Swift songs and stuff. Yeah, that meme. Go watch it.
Oh, we're halfway there. Ah! Living on a prayer. Love it. Go watch some of that as well. That's great. Right, we'll see you in 4 weeks' time. But please do come back for more videos, more fun, more madness, and we'll see you again soon. Bye, everyone.
Bye, everyone.
Press the magic button, Robbie.
Well, we're going round the Cape, golden shores to find, 900 miles of wind and waves smashing up the sides. We're going round the Cape, there is no other way.
For trade
and king
and countrymen,
we'll brave the foam and spray. So tell my love.